This is a 7 English podcast and you're listening to an adventure fantasy novel. The Desolate Era. Book 31, Starflow Realm. Chapter 11, The Stone Censer of Reunion. Ninedust chatted with Ji Ning as the two walked, while Dao Lord Leia just stared at Ning with a rather complex look on his face. "What is it, Dao Lord Leia?" Ning suddenly became aware of Leia's stares. "Brother Dark North, you probably do not yet understand what being given a chance to take a treasure away from Thundersouth Palace represents." Dao Lord Leia hesitated a moment, a complex look on his face. "The Starflow race cares deeply about one particular treasure inside this place. If you were able to bring it out and then gift it to our race, we would be willing to pay you an enormous price for it. The Starflow race would like to trade with me for it?" Ning was stunned. "Has no member of the Starflow Dao Lords been able to take any treasures away with them when they left?"
"There has."
Dao Lord Leia nodded. "Just one. Receiving the approval of the Eternal Lightning is incredibly difficult. There were others in our history who were able to endure the three blows and also endure the illusions, but they still were not acknowledged. Only now did Ning understood that gaining the Lightning Giant's approval was no simple task. Only a single member of our race was allowed to take a treasure away with him, and he chose a different one," Dao Lord Leia said. "My race desperately desires a chance to acquire that particular treasure. If you are willing to garner it and trade it with us, don't worry. I promise our race will pay almost any price. My avatar is in our headquarters right now, and I can complete the negotiations for you before you choose it and bring it out. You can choose where the trade will be transacted. Even if you wish to carry it out in the Endless Territories, we can make it happen." Ning was intrigued. It really did seem as though the Starflow race was in desperate desire of that treasure.
"What treasure is it?"
Ning asked.
"The Stone Censer of Reunion," Dao Lord Leia said.
"An incense burner?" Ning was rather puzzled. "Can it be the legendary?" A stunned look was on the Ninedust Sectlord's face. Ning looked at the look on Ninedust's face, then looked at the eager expression on Dao Lord Leia's. He instantly started to grow curious about this stone censer of reunion.
"Let me go take a look first.
Before doing so, Brother Leia, please do not tell your race about the fact that I have a chance to select a treasure." Ning said calmly, "Once you do, it's possible that one of your eternal emperors would suddenly charge to this place and lie in wait outside.
That would be troublesome."
"Don't worry." Dao Lord Leia nodded repeatedly. Ning decided to first take a look and see just what made this stone censer of reunion so special. If it was also extremely important to him, then he would probably immediately leave this place with it in tow. It would take time for the Starflow race to travel here. There was no way to use spatial teleportation within the Starflow River. Even Ning's ability to transcend dimensions was unable to pierce through the local region, thanks to the omnipresent power of the Starflow River. It would take quite some time for any member of the Starflow race's eternal emperors to get here. The three of them quickly arrived at a beautiful, crystalline pavilion. The walls of the pavilion were like white jade and semi-translucent, allowing them to be able to see through to the insides.
"How beautiful."
The three of them walked shoulder to shoulder through the pavilion. There were five prayer mats located on the ground, with a palm-sized incense burner located at the very center of the pavilion. The incense burner was both white and black, and it faintly emanated an aura of white smoke that was visible to the naked eye. It wafted out to an area of roughly 9 meters that perfectly covered the five prayer mats. There were also a number of paintings hanging from the walls and unfurled on the tables. Other treasures were on the tables as well. There was a bracelet that was engraved with some sort of bird carving, a pair of scissors that gleamed with black light, a pearl that emanated a freezing aura, and more. In total, there were 12 treasures on the dais.
"So these paintings were made by the master of this palace?"
Ning raised his head to look at the paintings. All of them were in the same style, and they naturally contained many of the mysteries of the Tao, primarily of the Tao of Lightning. And yet, they actually contained some elements of the Tao of the Sword as well. However, considering that Ning was the master of the Omega Sword Tao,
He viewed this person's sword Dao as being rather ordinary, perhaps on par with Emperor Mirror Snow's. There was also the Dao of illusions, and the Dao of painting infused into each artwork. Quite a few treasures here. Ning's attention had been focused on the incense burner in the center as soon as he had come in, but he was in no rush to inspect it. Instead, he first looked at the other 12 treasures on the table. An umbrella? A strange golden metal umbrella lay in front of him. The tip of the umbrella was incredibly sharp. Ning reached out to touch it, filling it with his god sense to learn some of its secrets. This magic treasure was known as the Golden Amber Sky Umbrella. It could be used to attack, but when the umbrella was opened it could also serve as a defensive treasure. It also contained a world unto itself that would be unleashed once the umbrella was opened, making it a domain-type treasure as well. The Amber Sky world would manifest in the surrounding area, suppressing the foe. The power of the Amber Sky world alone was on par with Ning's 9 Novescence Arts. It could be used for attack, defense, and suppression, and in suppression alone it was comparable to the 9 Novescence Arts. It must be remembered that Ning was only able to master those 9 arts due to a confluence of lucky factors, and in the end had succeeded only because he had learned an incredibly profound alchemy technique. And of course, given his Omega Sword Dao, once he reached the third step as a Dao Lord he would be able to unleash even greater power when using those 9 Novescence Arts to execute his sword arts. He would reach a level comparable to Dao Lord All God at that time. Despite that, the value of the Golden Amber Sky Umbrella was truly unfathomable. Ning was stunned by its worth. The 12 treasures of the hegemon truly were extraordinary. And what's this? Ning reached out to touch the bracelet engraved with the carving of a flying beast. This was the Sparrow Formation bracelet. It could be filled with hegemon-level energy or chaos jewels, then activated to unleash a mighty sparrow formation that could trap foes. Hegemons might be able to burst through the formation through raw force, but any weaker foe would be trapped until the power of the formation was depleted. Ning's eyes lit up. This is quite similar to the formation diagram Nine Dust holds in the palm of his hands. It's actually a multiple usage formation treasure. Treasures like this were incredibly valuable. Even if you encountered the 8 lords of the sacred cities or the likes of Patriarch Vulturas, you could use this treasure to trap them for a brief period of time, which you could then use to flee. Thus, treasures like this would virtually never be found for sale on the open market. Eternal emperors cherished them very highly. Only hegemons would be willing to bequeath them to later generations. They truly were of incalculable value. A fine treasure. Ning was deeply intrigued, but he then looked at the next treasure, a black disc that glimmered with a spot of light that roved inside of it. Every single treasure Ning saw interested him greatly. These treasures were of limited use to hegemons, but incredibly valuable to most eternal emperors. As for Dao Lords? They were simply unimaginable. For now, Ning was still the most intrigued by the Sparrow Formation bracelet. Now, let me take a look at the stone censer of reunion. Ning turned his head to look at the palm-sized incense burner located at the very center of the room. He walked over, then casually sat down on one of the prayer mats. Once he did, he sensed a surge of icy energy emanate from the prayer mats and into his entire body, causing his soul to calm down significantly. Ning wasn't too impressed by the effects of the prayer mat, as there were quite a few treasures with similar functions. But when the scent of the incense coming from the stone censer wafted into his nose. Rumble. The entire world turned silent. Ning's mind and soul emptied out in an almost Prajna-like state of epiphany, and many of his thoughts and questions pertaining to the Tao of the Sword quickly began to flash through his mind. More and more visualizations came to mind as he saw through one bottleneck after another. After an undeterminable period of time, Ning opened his eyes. Only then did he realize that he had sat here for 2 days and a full night. I actually was able to fully master the third stage of the Soul Heart Sword Intent. Ning was shocked. I've almost even finished mastering the new Heavenbreaker Sword Intent. He had spent 300,000 years drifting through the Starflow realm. His Yin Yang Sword Intent, his Blood Drop Sword Intent, and his shadowless sword intent had all broken through to the third stage. Now, after just sitting down for 2 days and a night, he had gained a terrifying number of new insights and breakthroughs. This is actually a meditation-type treasure? Ning stared at the palm-sized incense burner in disbelief. Although the state it allows you to into isn't as incredible as the true prajna state of epiphany, it's fairly close. This treasure would allow me to enter a state of epiphany at all times? To cultivators, what mattered the most? Treasures were secondary, insight into the Tao was what truly mattered. This was a treasure meant for meditating on the Tao. It was truly priceless. He'd never even heard of one of these things being available for sale. The only reason the Thunder South hegemon had left it behind was because he wasn't sure if he would survive the Dawn War, and so he had left this treasure behind. The Nine Dust Sect Lord and Tao Lord Leia had been in on rush to sit down. They had instead simply watched Ning. Tao Lord Leia said quite urgently, "Brother Dark North, are you willing to choose this incense burner and trade it to the Starflow race? Dark North, if you are willing to trade it to us ancient cultivators, we would similarly be willing to pay an incredible price for it," the Nine Dust Sect Lord said. The Desolate Era. Chapter 12, Tao Merge. Tao Lord Leia and the Nine Dust Sect Lord both looked at Ji Ning. Ning just continued to sit there, but he reached out with his right hand to gently stroke the stone incense burner in front of him. This sensor truly was quite odd. It had a white half and a black half, almost as though two different incense burners, one white and one black, had somehow been merged together. The black side felt as cold as ice, while the white side filled his palm with warmth. It was this strange union of these two marvelous properties that produced that faint white fragrance. Whoosh! Ning filled his finger with his immortal energy, beginning the process of binding the stone sensor of reunion to him. So that's how it is. Ning now understood. The stone sensor of reunion was able to produce a fragrant scent that would cause cultivators around it to enter a state of constant epiphany. However, the fragrance would eventually be used up, but so long as you could continue to pour more immortal energy into it, more of the fragrance would continue to be generated. In addition, the amount of immortal energy it consumed was fairly low. However, the amount of fragrance it produced was only enough for a single cultivator to constantly use. No wonder my 2 days of cultivation caused the surrounding mist to shrink from 9 meters to merely 6 meters. Ning couldn't help but sigh. This was merely the fragrance which was remaining and unused that was stored within the stone sensor. Dark North, are you sure that you will choose this sensor? The Nine Dust Sect Lord asked. Of course I'm certain. Ning nodded. A Tao cultivating treasure like this is incredibly rare and unquestionably priceless. Dark North, the nearby Tao Lord Leia looked anxiously at Ning. Are you willing to trade it to my Starflow race? The ancient cultivators have extremely deep roots and won't care that much about the stone sensor of reunion, and so the price that we are willing to pay will definitely exceed that of the ancient cultivators. You haven't even offered a price, but you are already claiming that your race will be able to offer more than mine? The Nine Dust Sect Lord smirked. Gentlemen. Ning shook his head. For now, I have no intention of trading this away. Nine Dust and Leia were both startled. It is extremely important to me as well. When the day comes that it is of no further use to me, I might be willing to trade it, Ning said. The Tao merge was incredibly difficult. The likes of Birchaloo, Tao Lord Skyax, Nine Dust, and Palace Lord Dawnstar had joined multiple Supreme Taos together. If they ever succeeded in the Tao merge, they would become hegemons. However, hegemons were incredibly rare. Ever since the Dawn War ended in the Terror Star Sea, the Endless Territories had only had 3 hegemons, no more, no less. As for Ning and his Omega Sword Tao, it would be even more difficult for him. If he succeeded in his Tao merge, he would probably be even more powerful than a hegemon, but were there any eternal emperors that were above the hegemon level of power? Thus far, at least, Ning had never discovered such a thing. In the alternate universe he had been in, the hegemons were still the most powerful figures. Even the leader of the Church of Annihilation in that universe had once been inferior to the Paragon of Pills. It was only thanks to the enormous gains and good luck he had reaped in the Genesis lands that he had skyrocketed in power to become the most powerful figure in that universe. However, the Dao this superlative lord of the church had used to complete his Dao merge and gain eternity for himself was clearly not that powerful. Thus far, Ning had already discovered the corpses of several hegemons. He had never, however, discovered anyone above the hegemon level. Ning fully understood that if he wished to become an eternal emperor who was superior to even hegemons, his path would be an incredibly difficult one. Eternal emperors were also able to slowly increase their level of strength. The Paragon of Pills herself was an example of an eternal emperor who managed to slowly train to the hegemon level. In the alternate universe, another good example of an eternal emperor who slowly became more powerful was Emperor Manasil. It was only after he became an eternal emperor that he slowly reached ever greater heights in the Dao of Seals. As for Dao lords? Even if they were given Dao cultivating treasures, the vast majority of them would still fail their Dao merge. In the end, eternal emperors made up the foundation of any race or clan. The only ones who didn't really care about Dao cultivating treasures were hegemons. Leia? Nine Dust glanced sideways at Dao Lord Leia. The Starflow race is rather lacking compared to mine. I don't think they would necessarily have a Dao cultivating treasure. I'll wager that they are in desperate need of one. He might have already leaked the information. Hell, one of their eternal emperors might be on the way right now. I did not. Dao Lord Lei immediately shook his head. I'm not that type of person, Brother Dark North. Don't worry. Gentlemen. Ning looked at them. Both of you know how tempting a target this Dao cultivating treasure makes me. Once word spreads, I'll never know another day of peace, in fact, I might very well die. Thus, Brother Nine Dust and Brother Leia, I'd like to ask the two of you to swear lifeblood oaths that you will never divulge the fact that I have a Dao cultivating treasure in my possession. You can't even tell anyone about me having acquired a treasure from Thunder South Palace. I know that insisting on you two swearing this lifeblood oath is a bit overbearing, but I hope you can understand the difficult straits I am in. Ning continued somberly, what I can promise is that here in Thunder South Palace, the three of us will share the usage of this stone censer. Consider this a form of compensation from me to the two of you. Given how bluntly you've put it, Dark North, how can I refuse? The Nine Dust sect lord immediately swore the oath. This fortune belongs to you, Dark North. In the end, it was not meant to be for our Starflow race. Dao Lord Leia shook his head, then swore a lifeblood oath as well. In truth, both of them knew that if they didn't swear the oath, Ning would probably immediately depart from this place and might even hide this Dao cultivating treasure somewhere. No matter what, it would be extremely difficult for the Starflow race to ever acquire it. Thank you. Ning let out a sigh of relief, then came to a decision. This stone censer is now the most important treasure I possess, far more important than even my North Bao swords. I cannot risk it being lost. Since my main body could perish at any time while out adventuring, Once I get back to the Endless Territories, I'll leave it with my Primal Twin. The Primal Twin was permanently stationed in the Three Realms and did not go out adventuring. It was indeed far safer to leave it there. In addition, the Primal Twin had also established its own heart world and was now incredibly powerful. For it to use the stone censer to train in the Dao was the same as the true body using it, as their souls and true souls were inextricably linked. After this, the three of them began to take turns using the stone censer of reunion. Every 1,000 years, they would alternate. One special property of the stone censer was that there was no way to use it under the effects of accelerated time. Or, to be precise, the fragrance emitted by the censer was simply too mysterious and profound. If you use temporal acceleration, you would need the fragrance to also be increased at a much faster pace, but this would cause the power of the temporal acceleration treasure to be depleted at an enormous pace. Even if one merely tried to train at double speed, the amount of immortal energy which would be used up would be more than one could bear. This Dao cultivating treasure truly is special. Ning and the others spent all their time slowly and honestly training in the Dao without using any temporal acceleration treasures at all. Despite that, they still trained far more quickly than they normally did. When you were stuck at a bottleneck, you would sometimes come to a complete halt no matter how much time you spent training. When you were in a praja state, however, you would improve far more quickly, allowing you to quickly bypass many bottlenecks. A mere 10,000 years later, Tao Lord Leia had been seated in the lotus position on the prayer mat, but he suddenly rose to his feet. This puzzled both Ning and Nine Dust. Leia, you haven't completed your 1,000-year mark yet. Why have you halted? Ning asked, puzzled. Even before coming to this palace, I had already reached my limit. Thanks to this Tao cultivating treasure, my Tao has become even more perfect than before. I cannot find any way to improve it in the slightest. Chapter 13, The Flower of Eternity. When will the Tao merge occur? Ji Ning asked. Right now. Tao Lord Leia looked at Ning. Brother Dark North, I would like to ask you to loan me the stone censer during the Tao merge process. A minor matter. Ning immediately nodded in acceptance. Tao Lord Leia waved his hand, causing a triangular altar to appear right next to him. The altar had three black bones atop it, and in the center of the bones was a depression. Tao Lord Leia took out a jade bottle, unplugged the stopper, then poured out a stream of bright silver liquid that quickly flowed into the depression. Tao Lord Leia then took one step forward, appearing above the altar. He then sat down in the lotus position at the very center of it. I spent quite a bit of effort in preparing this altar as well. Tao Lord Leia smiled towards Ning and Nine Dust. Nine Dust, I imagine that you ancient cultivators have even better tools at your disposal. Of course. The Nine Dust sect lord nodded. My race has a very suitable Tao merge location, and our verge level Tao lords will generally return to our homelands for their Tao merge for that reason. Only if some sort of special situation prevents them from coming home would they ever attempt the Tao merge outside. The ancient cultivators really do live up to their reputation, Tao Lord Leia said. My race does not have the ability to create a special Tao merge location. As he spoke, he glanced at Ning. Brother Dark North, I'd like to ask you to place the stone censer before the altar. All right. With but a thought, Ning sent the censer over towards the triangular altar, roughly 3 meters away from Tao Lord Leia. This allowed Tao Lord Leia to be able to absorb and inhale the fragrance which emanated from it. Tao Lord Leia waved his hand, causing a second palm-sized jade bottle to appear. After pulling out the stopper, he shook out a single round and smooth pill that emanated faint golden light. What looked like serpents could be seen swimming within the golden light. He opened his mouth and immediately swallowed the pill into his stomach. Another cold jade drake pill? Oh ho! It seems the Starflow race's resources are quite ample. Even I don't have a single such pill, the Nine Dust sect lord said with praise. Thanks to having studied the Seven Leaf Pill chapters, Ning knew quite a bit regarding the various pills that could be used to assist in the Tao merge. Nethercold Jade Drake pills allowed one to completely calm and empty out one's mind and heart, putting both into a state of inconceivable clarity. If used to engage in numerancy or calculations, one's mind would be able to move 1,000 times faster than normally. The Tao merge was a process that wasn't exactly short, but no Tao lord would describe it as long. Thus, the faster they were able to engage in the various calculations they needed to engage in during the time allotted them, the better. Nethercold Jade Drake pills were recorded within the Seven Leaf Pill chapters. They were ranked 8th amongst the various types of Daemerge assisting pills. But of course, there were only a total of 12 such pills even recorded down to begin with, and every single type of Daemerge assisting pill was incredibly valuable. As for the top 5, they truly were shockingly rare. The top 5 pills, even the Paragon of Pills herself had to use all the power and skill available to her to succeed at making the 2nd through 5th pills, and the process wasn't an easy one. In the end, it was truly a matter of talent. If the Paragon of Pills wished to make the 2nd ranked pill, she would have to pay an enormous price and spend an extremely long period of time while using up many precious materials. Ordinary Tao lords would kill themselves and still fail to find any of the 12 pills, to say nothing of the top 5. My race was lucky enough to stumble onto a few. I rendered a few merits and so was rewarded with a pill.
Tao Lord Leia smiled.
Fellow Taoists, I'm going to begin now. I hope that once my Tao merge concludes, I will have gained my eternity.
Gain eternity.
Both Ning and the Nine Dust Sect Lord quietly looked at him, mentally wishing him luck.
Whoosh.
Whoosh. Tao Lord Leia sat down in the lotus position. He closed his eyes, then took a deep breath. The fragrance in the surrounding area quickly flooded into his body. Slowly, ripples of power began to emanate from within his body, which started to shine with blurry golden light. This was the light of the Tao. He has started his Tao merge, Nine Dust said.
Ning watched carefully as well.
I wonder if he will succeed. Even as a mere spectator, Ning still felt a sense of pressure weighing down on his heart. The Tao merge, in the end, it was the final end which awaited all Tao lords.
His path is the Tao of Metal, Nine Dust murmured softly.
He's slowly beginning a final fusion of all of his Samsara Daylord level insights into the Tao of Metal. If his fusion is completely perfect, then he'll have created a Tao which shall last unto eternity. However, the slightest of imperfections shall result in failure.
Ning watched silently.
His own Omega Sword Tao might be extremely powerful, but it wasn't anywhere close to the perfect and eternal level. This was true for the first stage, the second stage, and even the hypothetical fourth stage.
What did eternity represent?
It meant that a particular Tao was completely flawless and perfect. The passage of time would not age that Tao in the slightest, only then could a Tao truly be worth of the title, eternal.
Tao Lord.
Leia was on par with the likes of Ning, Nine Dust, and Kong San. Most likely, he had only mastered a single supreme Tao. His Tao merge would be somewhat easier than Nine Dust's and Birchaloo's, as all he had to do was simply complete the Tao merge on the basis of the Tao foundation he had already set up. Ning was on an even higher level. For him, reaching true perfection in a Tao was almost impossibly hard. In Ning's estimation, based on the fact that his first stage Omega Sword Tao was an all-encompassing Tao which had already begun to resonate with the prime essence of the sword, if he did gain eternity with this Tao then it would become on par with the universe's prime essence of the sword itself. One could imagine how hard that would be to achieve.
Time continued to flow on.
Ning and Nine Dust both continued to watch. Generally speaking, a Tao merge would take at most a total of 9 years. It was difficult to estimate how short the shortest Tao merge would be. It was possible for failure to appear after just 2 weeks, this was a sign that one's deficiencies were very significant.
I wonder if he'll be able to crystallize his Flower of Eternity, Nine Dust murmured softly.
The Flower of Eternity. An expectant look was in Ning's eyes as well. When one embarked on the Tao merge, the Tao tree would once more begin to evolve. Upon reaching the verge, the Tao tree within the Jin Dan Chaos region would reach a total of 540,000 meters in height. It must be understood that this was the same height as an Eternal Emperor's Tao tree. There was no way for the Tao tree to grow any larger or any taller. When you began to Tao merge, you would need to perfectly merge together all of the insights of the Tao tree and form a beautiful, eternal flower. The flowering of the Tao tree and the blooming of this beautiful flower of eternity was a sign that the Tao merge had been successful. The flower of eternity would contain the gathered and combined insights of every single scrap of Tao the Tao tree possessed. But if you failed, the flower of eternity would wither just as it started to bloom.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
After Tao Lord Leia had spent 2 years in the Tao merge process, the golden light around his body suddenly expanded dramatically, becoming dazzling to behold. His aura began to rapidly increase in power and presence, eclipsing the auras of both Ning and Nine Dust. The aura continued to climb, rising above the level of any and every Tao Lord. He was someone who had mastered a single supreme Tao and was significantly more powerful than even Emperor Mirrors now had been. Once he gained eternity, he would be on the level of the eight lords of the sacred cities. The Tao merge truly could result in a skyrocketing level of power for any Tao Lord.
He's at the critical time now, the Nine Dust Sect Lord muttered softly.
Time to go all out. Success or failure will be determined right now. Ning watched nervously as well. The Dao merge had already gone on for 2 years. Clearly, Dao Lord Leia had reached the point where he needed to unleash all of his insights. He had to charge through this final barrier. If he succeeded, then it would be a complete success and he would have gained eternity. But if he was lacking in even the slightest, he would fail.
Boom. Boom.
Dao Lord Leia sat there, an agonized look on his face. Golden light radiated from his entire body in awe-inspiring fashion as the power of the Dao of Metal radiated out from him. His aura continued to grow more powerful, but it also began to shudder. Whoosh. Suddenly, all of the golden light vanished from him, and his aura quickly began to decay as well. Failure. Both the Nine Dust Sect Lord and Ning slowly shook their heads. No. Dao Lord Leia mumbled to himself. He had been able to see that a flower of eternity had already begun to take shape atop the Dao tree in his Jin Dan Chaos region, but the flower had withered away before having a chance to bloom. He had failed. His soul and true soul had been in the process of transforming into the Eternal Emperor level. The process had clearly failed, and both began to undergo a final, irreversible crumbling. This crumbling was extremely slow, but there was no way to stop it at all, as the crumbling was occurring at the very center of his being. If he didn't fight, the crumbling would take an extremely long time to complete, but each time he engaged someone else in battle he would be hastening the end of his own life. Still seated above the triangle altar, Dao Lord Leia opened his eyes. He looked at Ning and Nine Dust, a hint of grief in his eyes, then let out a pained smile. Fellow Taoists, the Dao merge truly is harder than all else under the heavens. I had my altar, used spirit pills, and had the assistance of the stone censer of reunion. I felt extremely good about my chances, but I still failed. The flower of eternity withered away as soon as the bud appeared. It didn't even have a chance to bloom. Clearly, I wasn't even close. Leia, failing the Dao merge is normal, Nine Dust said consolingly. In the end, very few are able to complete the Dao merge, and Dao lords on our level of power who can do so are even more rare. The Desolate Era. Chapter 14, Dao Lord Badlands. Ji Ning and Nine Dust could both understand how Dao Lord Leia felt right now. Cultivation was like climbing a mountain, you slowly started at the very bottom of the mountain, overcoming many difficulties before you finally reached the top. The final step you took next would determine if you rose into the heavens or fell into an endless abyss. Dao Lord Leia had failed his Dao merge, clearly. He had fallen into the endless abyss. His soul and true soul had already begun to crumble, and he could already see his future death. His path of cultivation was about to come to an end. Even though he had mentally prepared himself long ago, he would still feel great pain. I've cultivated for many years, but it all ends today. Dao Lord Leia shook his head, then let out a hoarse chuckle. When I was young, I fought hard to climb to the very top. Only then did I learn how tough things were for my race. After becoming a Dao Lord, my every thought was consumed with taking care of my race. It's been too long, and I'm far too tired. I've spent my entire long life in the Terror Star Sea, Dao Lord Leia said. I've never even visited the Endless Territories. Dao Lord Leia rose to his feet, then waved his hand and put away the triangle altar. Brother Dark North. Brother Nine Dust. Dao Lord Leia looked at the two of them. I'm going to leave now. I plan to pay a visit to the Endless Territories and learn about it. In fact, I might even go off into the Great Dark. Before I die, I want to see as much as of the universe as I can. Ning and the Nine Dust Sect Lord no longer knew what to say. No need to send me off. Dao Lord Leia strode quickly towards the exit. The two watched as Dao Lord Leia left, both filled with regret. Dao Lord Leia no longer cared one whit about Thunder South Palace, electing to leave immediately. Ning and the Nine Dust Sect Lord, however, still did care, because the various paintings hanging on the walls of the palace represented various techniques that the Lord of the Palace had left behind for others. Thankfully, he didn't go crazy. The Nine Dust Sect Lord shook his head. I've seen Verge-level Dao Lords go absolutely insane after they failed their Dao merge. He trained since he was young and has cultivated his entire life. Ning continued to stare in the direction Dao Lord Leia had left. He trained tens of thousands of chaos cycles, but all of a sudden he failed his Dao merge and brought his cultivation path to an abrupt halt. This would be extremely disheartening for any cultivator. It makes sense for some to be mentally affected by it.
Humph.
There are some evil Dao Lords who normally keep their worst impulses in check and are afraid to act too rashly for fear of being killed by other major powers. After they fail their Dao merge and are guaranteed to perish, they become absolutely fearless and even more detestful than before. The Nine Dust Sect Lord shook his head. But of course, they'll die in their madness. I wonder what we'll end up like when we fail our Dao merge? The Nine Dust Sect Lord suddenly said. When we fail our Dao merge? Ning stared blankly. Would he fail his Dao merge? Right now, there was no way for him to be sure as to how he would react. Maybe we'll both succeed and gain eternity for ourselves.
Ning smiled.
Huh. Right. We'll gain eternity for sure. The Nine Dust Sect Lord nodded. I'll be a hegemon when that happens. We ancient cultivators will have two hegemons.
Huh.
But both of them understood that the path to eternity was an incredibly difficult one. Normally, less than 1 in 100,000 Dao Lords would be able to gain eternity, and virtually all of them were ordinary Dao Lords. Ning and Nine Dust continued to calmly train within the Thunder South Palace of the Starflow River, and both improved quite rapidly. Finally, after spending 30,000 years at the Thunder South Palace, the Nine Dust Sect Lord made his breakthrough. Rumble, an aura of awesome power swept out from the Nine Dust Sect Lord. He opened his eyes, his face wreathed with smiles.
Huh.
I, Redwater, have finally broken through. A Dao Lord of the Fourth Step. I've finally become a Dao Lord of the Fourth Step. This has been incredibly difficult. Going from the third step to fourth step was 1,000 times harder than going from the first step to the third step.
Huh.
I've finally broken through. Congratulations, Brother Nine Dust, the nearby Ning said. Yes, this is indeed worth celebrating. I was trapped at the third step for far, far too long. The Nine Dust Sect Lord smiled as he looked at Ning. It was all thanks to this stone sensor of reunion. If it wasn't for it, I would have wasted another chaos cycle or two before making my breakthrough. I had already gained certain insights in the trial the ancient ancestor left behind, allowing me to vault to a new level on this trip. With this step you now stand at the very peak of power amongst Dao Lords, Nine Dust, Ning said. Nine Dust nodded, looking rather pleased. He was someone who had perfectly joined together two supreme Daos. Now that he had reached the fourth step, he immediately stood amongst the ranks of the absolute most powerful Dao Lords in the world. He was on the same level as Dao Lord Skyax or Palace Lord Dawnstar. There might be differences in power due to different secret arts and different treasures, but those differences wouldn't be too great, they were all on the same overall level of power. The more powerful you were, the more difficult it would be to go from the third step to the fourth step. Dao Lord Badlands, for example, had also been trapped at the third step for a very, very long period of time. Dark North, you are no longer a match for me, Nine Dust said quite smugly. That's not necessarily true, Ning replied. Don't forget that I'm a Heart Force cultivator. I've gained some insight into the illusions of the Thunder South Hegemon over these past few years as I've studied his paintings. You might not be able to fully resist my illusions now. If he could trap his enemy in illusions for even an instant, it would have an impact on how any fight would result. Nine Dust blinked, then immediately said, "Humph, I need a bit of time to solidify my foundation, as I've just recently made my breakthrough. Give me some more time to further strengthen my soul and your illusions won't be able to touch me at all." Nine Dust's face suddenly tightened. My Dao is now strong enough. I've reached the verge of the Dao merge as soon as I reached the fourth step. I should make more preparations as well, right now, I have no confidence in my Dao merge chances whatsoever. Ning was startled.
Right.
Nine Dust was now at the verge as well. The distant Badlands territory. In the Badlands Everworld, there was a legendary place known throughout the endless territories, the Waveshift Realm. This was a realm that had been left behind by Emperor Waveshift himself. He was renowned as the number one numerancy expert of the endless territories, and was far more powerful than the current Dao Lord Badlands. He was a mysterious man who appeared and disappeared without warning, and even the three hegemons found it difficult to deal with him as his schemes and calculations were simply too frightening. Emperor Waveshift had hidden valuable treasures within the Waveshift realm. This was something he had said publicly before leaving the endless territories and venturing off into the endless great dark. Many generations of Dao Lords had entered this place to try their luck, and Dao Lord Soul Sky was one of them. The Waveshift realm was a place that seemed to be covered by an enormous blurry barrier. The dim light of sunset covered this entire realm, and some cultivators could be seen passing by it on occasion. Most kept a very safe distance, as the Waveshift realm was simply too dangerous. Rumble! Suddenly, a dazzling streak of green light shot out from the Waveshift realm. This streak of light stretched out countless kilometers, streaking up into the heavens and piercing through the world barrier protecting the entire Badlands Everworld. Rumble! A second dazzling streak of bloody light shot out, just as wide and large as the first one. It shot out towards another direction. Black light, violet light, azure light, a total of 9 streaks of light shot out. These 9 streaks of light looked almost like a peacock spreading its feathers as they shot towards different directions. They pierced through everything in their path, be it mountains or mist, but they seemed completely illusory. They caused no damage at all to anything they passed through, leaving even the grass completely untouched. What's going on? What is this? Is something happening? The Badlands Everworld was the center of the entire Badlands territory. Countless cultivators were gathered here, and all of them were puzzled, especially the elder gods and true gods. However, when they saw the light shoot out from the Waveshift realm, they all realized that this was something far beyond their level. What's going on in the Waveshift realm? Is something happening? The Badlands Court was the paramount power within the Badlands Everworld, and its disciples all stared off in the distance. Husband. A married couple was standing together in the skies, staring off into the distance. The beautiful wife turned to look at her husband, concerned. An azure-robed Dao Lord Badlands was staring towards the light, a complex look on his face. He shook his head slightly. I was too proud and rash, too certain in my numerancy skills. Compared to Emperor Waveshift, I'm still lacking by quite a bit. I just caused a bit of a catastrophe. I don't think there will be any way to hide this. Ugh. I only have my avatar inside, but Big Brother Soul Sky will be in trouble. Caused a catastrophe? The beautiful wife asked worriedly, will it impact our Badlands court? The two of us should leave the Badlands territory for now and hide for a time. For now, let us just leave an avatar behind to watch over things, Dao Lord Badlands said. Hide? She had never imagined that things would be so grave that they would have to flee and hide somewhere else. The Desolate Era. Chapter 15, Void Sea Jade Seal. Soon, many Dao Lords will be charging to this sector, Dao Lord Badlands said solemnly. If my true body remains here, I might very well fall. However, so long as I leave and ensure they cannot find my true body, they won't dare to cause our Badlands court any trouble. In the end, my Dao of Numerancy is a Dao for divination, not battle. My skills lie in avoiding trouble and finding fortunes. The beautiful woman nodded. Let's go. Right away. A short while later, Dao Lord Badlands and his wife silently departed from the Badlands Everworld, leaving only an avatar behind to guard over the Badlands court. The Dao of Numerancy was indeed an extremely troublesome Dao for everyone, but it was highly unsuited for actual battle. Dao Lord Badlands himself almost never went out adventuring or into battle. As a Dao Lord of the third step who had reached an extremely high level in the Dao of Numerancy, he logically should have been on the same level as the likes of Nine Dust, at the third step, or Kong San, but in reality he was much weaker in combat. He was just barely on par with the likes of Soul Sky and Clearwind. This was his greatest weakness. However, his skills lay in avoiding trouble, when he encountered enemies he was unable to defeat, he'd quickly move to avoid them. In the end, the Tao of Numerancy was about divination, not omniscience. As a result, he had suffered greatly for his overconfidence alongside Tao Lord Soul Sky in the Waveshift realm. Clearly, even he fell for the traps left behind by Emperor Waveshift, and so he hurriedly slunk away from his own everworld. 9 beams of light have appeared in the skies over the Waveshift realm. Something big just happened. No matter what, the Badlands Everworld was still the core of this territory. The Tao Alliance had stationed a number of cultivators here who were responsible for diplomacy with Tao Lord Badlands and watching over the various treasure auctions. In addition, some of the supreme organizations within the Endless Territories had inserted scouts to watch over the Waveshift realm. Although these scouts weren't that powerful, they were only required to keep a long-term watch over Waveshift City. Waveshift Realm was simply an incredibly famous place of the Endless Territories. Hurry up and send a report. Something big has happened in the Waveshift Realm. The scouts had been waiting here for far too long with nothing to report. Some had been waiting for tens of thousands of chaos cycles, and it was all for the sake of critical moments like this. Thus, none of them dared to slacken off. Soon, the news spread from the Badlands territory to the rest of the Endless Territories. A dazzlingly beautiful green planet. This world had countless cultivators living within it. In one corner of this vast world, there was an ordinary wooden house that merely had a single old man seated within it. The old man had curly green hair and a pair of horns on his head, and his eyes were lidded. He had been seated here for more than 10,000 chaos cycles. He had been alive for far, far too long. Patriarch. Patriarch. A voice rang out from afar. The green-haired elder opened his eyes, and they seemed to contain the boundless vastness of the universe itself within them. His gaze was gentle as he stared outside. A golden-robed figure was leading a green-haired man who had an exalted aura towards the patriarch. The green-haired man landed, then said respectfully, "Patriarch." He had become a lord of a sacred city, and in power he was roughly on par with this particular patriarch, but he still showed the old man the utmost of respect. The old man had shown him great kindness. Although they weren't master and disciple, he owed the old man as much as any master. The old man had also done much for their entire homeland, far more than anyone else. Without the patriarch, their lineage would have been wiped out long ago. "Qixiao, why have you come back to our homeland to meet with me?" The green-haired elder smiled. "Patriarch." Emperor Qixiao said seriously, "Do you still remember Emperor Waveshift?"
"Remember him?"
"Of course I remember him." A nostalgic look appeared on the old man's ancient face. "After I became an eternal emperor, I spent countless years studying the Tao of Numerancy myself. I had once believed myself to be a preeminent master of this Tao in the Endless Territories, but after meeting Waveshift and testing myself out I realized that I wasn't even close to being a match. His skill in Numerancy vastly, vastly surpassed my own."
"You are being too modest, Patriarch."
Emperor Waveshift relied on the Tao of Numerancy to become an emperor, of course he was skilled in it. "You, on the other hand, only started studying it after becoming an emperor. He's left the Endless Territories long ago. In the present day, you are number one in this Tao," Emperor Qixiao said.
"For now, I suppose.
There's a young fellow named Tao Lord Badlands in the Badlands Territory who is even more talented than Emperor Waveshift was in Numerancy. He's a Tao Lord of the third step but is already incredible at Numerancy. Once he becomes a Tao Lord of the fourth step, he'll probably surpass me in that Tao and become a king of the Endless Territories." The old man shook his head. Moments later, his face tightened slightly as the illusion of the cosmos within his eyes suddenly vanished. He raised his head to look at Emperor Qixiao.
"Have you come here because of the Badlands Territory,
no? To be precise, you have come because of the Waveshift realm?"
"Impressive, Patriarch."
Emperor Qixiao said hurriedly, "I have indeed come because of the Waveshift realm. Just now, I received word that something major has happened there." 9 streaks of light shot out from the Waveshift realm and went through the entire Badlands Everworld.
that's quite a commotion. Can it be that the void sea jade seals have emerged? The old man was stunned. That was my first reaction as well. Before Emperor Wave Shift departed, he fashioned multiple void sea jade seals. However, he only left one of them to the Tao Alliance. He put the other five within his own Wave Shift realm, Emperor Qixiao said. The old man nodded. Back then, Brother Wave Shift told me that if any Eternal Emperor dared to forcibly enter his realm, all five seals would instantly be destroyed. Only Tao Lords would be permitted to acquire them. Patriarch, these seals are supreme Tao merge treasures. Emperor Qixiao said hurriedly, if we can acquire those five seals, we might be able to produce one or two formidable Eternal Emperors for our race.
Yes.
The old man nodded. Void Sea Jade Seals, they were described as supreme Tao merge treasures because they were publicly acknowledged as being the best treasures for assisting cultivators in the Tao merge. No treasures surpassed
them.
Void Sea Jade Seals were single-use items. After you acquired them and as you prepared for your Tao merge, you could form an illusory body within the seal, then use that illusory body to test out the Tao merge. The process would be identical to that of the actual Tao merge you would undergo. Even if you failed your Tao merge, it wouldn't harm your true body in the slightest. It was equivalent to giving you an additional shot at the Tao merge. This additional experience was more than enough to drive any Tao Lord mad with lust. Why was the Tao merge so terrifying? It was precisely because the Tao merge was a one-time event. If you were even slightly lacking, you would fail and never have another shot at it. If you had multiple shots at it, then obviously your second attempt would benefit from your previous experience and give you a far better chance at succeeding in the Tao merge. However, given how incredible the Void Sea Jade Seals were, they were naturally incredibly rare as well. They could only be fashioned through the usage of a strange treasure known as Void Sea Jade, and they could only be fashioned by Emperor Wave Shift, who had reached truly inconceivable heights in the Tao of Numerancy. Prior to his departure, he had used up his entire supply of Void Sea Jade to create these six seals. He had left one seal with the Tao Alliance and the other five at the Wave Shift realm. This was why so many generations of Tao Lords had ventured off into the Wave Shift realm, but thus far none of them had been able to find the Void Sea Jade Seals. The power of the Void Sea Jade Seals is enough to allow a Tao Lord who has a single Supreme Tao to undergo a single full Tao Merge attempt. However, if that Tao Lord has perfectly fused multiple Supreme Taos together, he'll only be able to make it halfway through the Tao Merge before the power of the seal is used up. The old man sighed. This was the limit to what the Void Sea Jade Seal could accomplish. If someone who had joined together multiple Supreme Taos together succeeded into the Tao Merge, that person would become a hegemon. There was no way a Void Sea Jade Seal could fully divine such a process. However, a Tao Lord who had a single Supreme Tao would be able to try out an entire complete Tao Merge. It must be remembered that there were incredibly few figures in the endless territories who were capable of comprehending and mastering multiple Supreme Taos. Thus, these seals were more than enough for the vast majority of Tao Lords. Even the most ungodly powerful of Tao Lords would be able to at least divine half of the Tao Merge process. Patriarch, can you verify that the disturbance in the Wave Shift realm was indeed caused by the emergence of the Void Sea Jade Seals? Emperor Qixiao asked. Let me take a look. The old man closed his eyes and began to engage in numerancy calculations as strange ripples of power appeared around him. A long time later, the old man opened his eyes and nodded. Tell the younger members of our race that the Wave Shift realm truly has unleashed its Void Sea Jade Seals. I imagine that Brother Wave Shift did this deliberately to draw many Tao Lords to his realm, which is why he didn't hide anything and allowed me to calculate it all with ease. Any of the top 10 numerancy experts in the endless territories is capable doing the same. Void Sea Jade Seals? Emperor Qixiao's eyes lit up. If we're certain, then we have to get them for ourselves. This is a 7 English podcast and you're listening to an adventure fantasy novel. The Desolate Era. Book 31, Starflow Realm. Chapter 16, Everyone Gathering. Within an region of space that was completely cut off from the rest of the universe.
This was a region that was filled with endless blood flames that seemed to form an entire ocean. Every single flame possessed awesome might and was capable of easily incinerating a Dao Lord of the fourth step. At the very center of the flames, there was an imperial throne that seemed to have been carved out of white bone. The enormous white bone throne hung there, and above it stood a silver-haired man whose hands were resting on the armrests. The man stared at the endless flames, and his heart and mind seemed to be completely one with the world.
Gorsh!
A voice suddenly rang out within the empty region.
Come forth!
The silver-haired man was startled. Ever since learning that his most talented progeny, Gorho, had been recruited by the Brightshore Kingdom, he had felt much at ease. He had temporarily chosen to enter their racial lands to train. Why was it that he was now being ordered to come out?
Coming, the silver-haired man said respectfully.
Whoosh! He disappeared from atop the throne of white bone, which continued to eternally hang there above the endless sea of blood flames. The silver-haired man appeared within a beautiful, ancient palace. The throne of this palace was occupied by an exceedingly handsome youth who was dressed in gaudy black robes and whose eyes seemed to contain the vast cosmos within them.
Emperor, the silver-haired man said respectfully.
Gorsh, I just received word that Void Sea Jade Seals have appeared within the wave-shift realm of the Dao Alliance's Badlands territory. The icy-faced black-robed youth spoke in an extremely calm voice. Although he looked very young, he was actually the oldest and most venerable Eternal Emperor of the entire Aeonian race. He was perpetually stationed within the core palace of the Aeonian Kingdom, and it was his responsibility to watch over their ancestral lands.
Void Sea Jade Seals?
The silver-haired man revealed a stunned look.
You've reached the verge of
the Dao merge long ago, and you are fast approaching the great limit, the black-robed youth said coldly.
You are, at present, the most powerful Dao Lord of our race.
Although the Jade Seals are not strong enough to allow you to fully experience the complete Dao merge, you'll at least be able to experience part of it. This is a rare opportunity for you and your Dao merge. However, word of this has already spread and all six of the major powers of the Endless Territories have been informed. I trust that many Verge-level Dao Lords are already on their way. What's worse, you are an Aeonian while Emperor Wave Shift was of the Dao Alliance. It is entirely possible that he might have prepared something nasty for our race there. If you go, you'll take on a certain degree of risk.
You can choose for yourself whether or not you wish to go, the black-robed youth said.
Everyone in the outside world refers to me as King Gorsh, but in the end I'm just a king, not an emperor. The silver-haired man said in a low voice, my limit approaches, and I have no confidence in my Dao merge chances at all. Although this opportunity is filled with peril, I still have to give it a try. If I can acquire one of those seals, my chances at the Dao merge shall become much greater.
Right.
The black-robed youth nodded. The Brightshore Kingdom. A figure suddenly appeared out of nowhere atop an ordinary-looking wasteland. It was a white-bearded old man who was dressed in snowy white robes and who had six horns on his head. He stood there atop the lands, then opened his mouth, nine stone.
Rumble,
the vast wilderness began to shake as the earth itself began to bulge upwards. An enormous four-legged stone behemoth that was covered in countless sharp spikes emerged from beneath the ground, leaving behind an enormous crater that was over 100 million kilometers in circumference. The Brightshore Imperials were all Chaos God Beasts, and they were legendary for their size.
Hegemon.
The four-legged stone behemoth stared at the almighty Hegemon. You merged yourself into the Earth itself to better understand the Dao of Earth. Of the Brightshore Imperials, you are closest to the lifespan limit. Are you confident in your Dao merge chances? The Brightshore Hegemon asked. In truth, the almighty Hegemon was quite worried. Although the Brightshore Imperials had many generations of Chaos God Beasts, thus far only a single one had become a Hegemon, himself. Fortunately, he was powerful enough all by himself to overawe the entire Endless Territories. However, the fact that his race had yet to produce a second emperor meant that he was forced to continuously kidnap some of the geniuses of the other races of the Endless Territories. Palace Lord Dawnstar, Birchaloo, Ji Ning, all of them had been kidnapped. They now belong to the 12 palaces of Brightshore, which were actually more powerful than the Brightshore Imperials themselves. But of course, they were no match for the hegemon. I am not confident, Ninestone rumbled softly. Void Sea Jade Seals have appeared within the Waveshift realm of the Badlands territory. You might have a shot at one of them, the Almighty Hegemon said. However, this will be filled with danger. These seals were fashioned the most skilled numerancy expert the Endless Territories has ever seen, Emperor Wave Seal, and he had to use up his supply of Void Sea Jade in order to create them. There's only a few of the seals, and they've aroused the attention of quite a few Verge-level Dao Lords. Many reclusive, normally low-key Dao Lords have all made their appearances. You can choose for yourself whether or not you wish to go. The Almighty Hegemon disappeared into thin air after speaking. Waveshift Realm of the Dao Alliance? Ninestone's body blurred as he transformed into a human shape. He now looked like an incredibly muscular black-armored man whose eyes were as still as a pool of dead water. Ninestone was known amongst the Brightshore Imperials as the Ninth King. Void Sea Jade Seals have actually appeared? Dao Lord Skyaxe and Dao Lord Solman were seated within a flying vessel in the void. What's this? Dao Lord Solman called out with surprise. Void Sea Jade Seals have appeared in the Waveshift realm, Dao Lord Skyaxe said. I just received word of this. I imagine the Brightshore Kingdom should receive word soon as well. Let me ask. Dao Lord Solman nodded, then soon nodded a second time. The 12 palaces have just received word as well. The Jade Seals really have appeared. Shall we go? Dao Lord Skyaxe looked at Solman. Of course. Solman nodded. This is our best shot at the Dao Merge. Let's go. The two immediately changed their plans, turning around their flying vessel and sending it towards the Waveshift realm instead. Within an ordinary mortal city. Countless mortals lived in this region for up to 100 years. They lived ordinary lives and had to work hard for their living. This city had a famous blacksmith who was very skilled in creating weapons, especially sabers. However, he only smithied when he was in the right mood, and his smithy was only occasionally operational. I'll give you 2 golden vast luck coins. Help me forge a suitable saber for me. A youth and his servants were present, and they spoke and acted in a very arrogant manner. 2 golden vast luck coins. The ordinary-looking blacksmith, dressed in hemp clothes, called out in astonishment, each of these are worth as much as 10,000 ordinary gold coins, right? Precisely, the youth said. Proudly. What a fortune. But, haven't you heard? When I don't want to work, no one in the world can force me. The blacksmith snickered, run along home, kid. 2 golden vast luck coins aren't enough. How many do you want? The youth was anxious now. The blacksmith was about to speak when he suddenly paused. The hegemon is saying that Void Sea Jade Seals have just appeared? This is probably the best chance that I, Dawnstar, will have to improve my Dao Merge odds. The blacksmith's eyes became as tranquil as the sea as he glanced at the youth and the others. Cancel it all. Whoosh. The entire city, in fact, the entire world, all vanished into motes of glittering, astral saber light. All of the living beings had been nothing more than incarnations created by saber light, not actual living beings. This was nothing more than a training mechanism he engaged in. Waveshift realm, He sheathed his machete into the scabbard on his back. He had a look in his eyes that was calm but which could bring fear to countless cultivators. Moments later, he vanished into thin air after taking a single step. The Dao Alliance, the Ionians, the Brightshore Kingdom, the Aberrants, the ancient cultivators, all of them quickly received word. Even the powerful Dao Lords of the Dark Kingdom were intrigued. The Ionians were on rather bad terms with the Dao Alliance, but for the sake of the Dao Merge, King Gorsh and several other Verge-level Dao Lords decided to brave the risk and give it a shot. The same was true for the Dark Kingdom. Verge-level Dao Lords, for the sake of completing their Dao Merge, were absolutely fearless. They began to stealthily move towards the Badlands territory as well. Even the most powerful of Dao Lords would feel despair when faced with the Dao Merge. When the legendary Void Sea Jade Seals, the most supreme Dao Merge treasures, suddenly appeared, countless Dao Lords were intrigued and agitated. There were many Dao Lords who were low-key, but that didn't mean they were weak. Emperor Heartsword was a classic example. He was very low-key, and only fought after becoming a Dao Lord of the fourth step due to an irreconcilable grudge. He gained great fame through that battle, and when he succeeded in his Dao Merge he became the most dazzling Eternal Emperor in existence. Even now, people whispered stories about him. Another example was Dao Lord Everstarter of the Sword Palace of the Brightshore Kingdom. He had also been a very low-key figure who lived in the Sword Palace and rarely went out adventuring. However, when the ancient cultivators went too far in their actions and forced his hand, he slew consecutively three of their verge-level Dao Lords and then defeated one of their emperors. He was publicly acclaimed as the most powerful Dao Lord of the Endless Territories in his time. Clearly, the appearance of these seals caused many of the normally low-key but incredibly powerful Dao Lords to make their appearances. None of them would hesitate over something which could increase their chances at completing their Dao Merge. Not even death could stop them. The Desolate Era. Chapter 17, Trouble for Vast Heaven Palace. The Terror Star Sea. The Starflow River. Within Thunder South Palace, Ji Ning and the Nine Dust Sect Lord were still training calmly here. The Nine Dust Sect Lord's face suddenly turned pale. He opened his eyes and called out loudly, "Dark North. Dark North. What is it?" Ning was seated atop a prayer mat and was using the beneficial effects of the Stone Censer of Reunion to train. All five of his Supreme Sword Daos had reached the third stage, but he was stuck at the bottleneck of actually combining them together into the third stage Omega Sword Dao. Although the Stone Censer was effective in helping him meditate on the Dao, the toughest bottlenecks would still be quite hard to resolve. Something big just happened. The Nine Dust Sect Lord looked rather excited. "Have you heard of the Wave Shift Realm in the Badlands territory of your Dao Alliance?"
"I do." Ning was startled. That place was quite close to his own homeland, the Three Realms. His big brother Soul Sky was in that realm right now. How could he not be familiar with that place? "The Void Sea Jade Seals have emerged from the Wave Shift Realm," the Nine Dust Sect Lord said excitedly. "All six of the major organizations in the Endless Territories already know about this matter. Many Verge-level Dao Lords have gone crazy. Most who have heard about this have already headed to the Badlands Territory and are going to enter the Wave Shift Realm."
"Void Sea Jade Seals?" Ning was stunned. That was a supreme Dao Merge treasure. Any Verge-level Dao Lord would go crazy over such an item. The entire reason why so many Verge-level Dao Lords dared to charge into the Terror Star Sea and other terrifyingly dangerous place was because they had long ago stopped worrying about the chances of dying. To them, their only goal was to do their utmost to increase their chances in the Dao Merge. When word of the Void Sea Jade Seal's emergence spread, it only made sense that many Verge-level Dao Lords would immediately charge into the Wave Shift Realm. "Big Brother Soul Sky is there." Ning's heart clenched. Not good. It was already dangerous for Soul Sky to traverse the Wave Shift Realm to begin with. Now that many Verge-level Dao Lords had also joined the fray, Soul Sky simply wasn't that strong, compared to many of those freaks. He would be in even more danger than before. "I'm still very, very far away from hitting my lifespan limit." But, the Nine Dust Sect Lord's eyes were glowing with excitement. "Void Sea Jade Seals are legendary, supreme Dao Merge treasures. Ever since Emperor Wave Shift left, there has been no word of any of these treasures. If we miss this opportunity, we can probably forget about ever having a chance to acquire them. Dark North, I've already decided to go to the Wave Shift Realm. How about you? Why don't we go together? If we join forces, we really would have nothing and no one to fear." Now that he was at the fourth step, Nine Dust was on the same level of power as Palace Lord Dawnstar, Dao Lord Sky Axe, King Gorsh, and similar fighters. However, he wouldn't dare to claim invincibility. For example, he was vulnerable to dangerous illusions and extremely powerful Heart Force cultivators. It must be remembered that Ning was merely at the second tier amongst Heart Force cultivators.
If the Nine Dust Sect Lord had to deal with the likes of the Palace Lord of the Heartforce Palace of the Brightshore Kingdom, he really wasn't confident in his chances. However, things were different for Ning. Ning might not be able to do anything to them, but he was more than strong enough to defend. When dealing with soul and true soul related attacks, defense was much easier than attack. So long as the difference wasn't too ridiculously large, Heart Force cultivators would generally be able to endure enemy Heart Force attacks.
Let's go.
Ning nodded. We naturally can't give up a chance like this.
Ha ha ha.
Wonderful. I imagine that the most powerful of the Endless Territory's famous Dao Lords will be headed there. And that's just on the surface. I imagine many of the powerful but low-key Dao Lords will be headed there as well. Nine Dust said excitedly, Dark North, neither of us are all that famous in the Endless Territories, but when we join forces we really will have no one to fear.
Agreed.
We can deal with any type of attacks. Ning felt quite confident as well. The two of them weren't very famous just yet. Ning had killed Kong San, there were still very few who knew the name, Dao Lord Dark North. As for the Nine Dust Sect Lord, he wasn't that famous either. Both weren't nearly as well known as King Gorsh, Skyax, Dawnstar, or other such figures.
Let's not waste time.
Let's head in that direction immediately, Ning said.
Agreed.
Let's move right away. If we are too slow, it might end up being taken by others. The Nine Dust Sect Lord didn't want to waste time either.
The Endless Territories.
Vast Heaven Palace. Dao Lord Soul Sky and Dao Lord Battlemaster were already meeting about this matter.
What?
Dao Lord Battlemaster stared at Dao Lord Soul Sky in astonishment.
Ugh.
Neither I nor Badlands imagined that something like this would happen. We were moving quite carefully, and you know how skilled Badlands is in numerancy. Neither of us expected that we'd end up falling into Emperor Waveshift's trap. We just kicked over the hornet's nest.
Dao Lord Soul Sky shook his head.
Based on what I know, the top organizations of the Endless Territories already know about this. The emergence of the Void Sea Jade Seals will definitely attract an enormous number of Verge-level Dao Lords to hasten towards us. Compared to them, we're nothing.
Big Brother Soul Sky, don't worry too much.
My guess is that Emperor Waveshift planned this out long ago. There's no way he would allow anyone to acquire those Jade Seals with ease. Anyone who touched them would immediately cause certain spells to be activated that would cause all of this to happen. The entire point was to draw the Verge-level Dao Lords of the Endless Territories over to the Waveshift realm to fight over the seals, Battlemaster said.
Right.
This was indeed part of Emperor Waveshift's plan. Soul Sky acknowledged it as well. How could any single Dao Lord possibly be allowed to acquire all five of these legendary seals? Of course their emergence would cause a huge fight and struggle. Battlemaster carried out a few calculations, then let out a shocked sigh.
All I can see is a storm of blood and death.
The Waveshift realm is going to become an utter charnel house of frenzied slaughter and murder. I can't even calculate how many Dao Lords will die in there. Major powers skilled in numerancy should be able to calculate how incredibly deadly the Waveshift realm will be, but no amount of danger will prevent these Dao Lords from coming, Dao Lord Soulsky said. Often, less than 1 in 100,000 Dao Lord would be able to succeed in the Dao merge, and the vast majority of those who succeeded were extremely ordinary Dao Lords. The incredibly powerful Dao Lords, the Endless Territories had been around for countless eons, but how many powerful Dao Lords ended up becoming Eternal Emperors? Based on their calculations, it was highly unlikely that any of the powerful Dao Lords of this generation would successfully become Eternal Emperors. Thus, everyone would be absolutely fearless in their pursuit of the seals.
Battlemaster, I suspect that Vast Heaven Palace will be in danger as well, Dao Lord Soulsky said.
This is all my fault. When I went to the Waveshift world, I didn't imagine what an enormous commotion this would cause. Thus, I didn't hide the fact that I was heading there. I imagine that a number of people in the Endless Territories know that I entered Waveshift Palace long ago. Those Dao Lords might come here and seek out trouble for Vast Heaven Palace. Your true body should lead our brothers away from here and hide for a time.
hide?
Dao Lord Battlemaster frowned.
Very well. I can already vaguely sense. That trouble will indeed be coming. I'll immediately lead our brothers somewhere else to hide for a time. Of the Dao Lords of Vast Heaven Palace, Soul Sky, Brightfish, and Ning all had only avatars present. The only Dao Lord who had both his true body and his avatar here was Battlemaster. Battlemaster was also skilled in numerancy. Although he was still inferior to Badlands in numerancy despite having reached the fourth step when the latter was still stuck at the third, he was still someone who had become a Dao Lord of the fourth stance through numerancy. If he led the brothers of Vast Heaven Palace to hide, there probably really wouldn't be many who could find them. Just as they were discussing this matter, "Big brother!" A voice suddenly rang out as a golden-robed youth walked over. It was Ning's avatar. "Ji Ning." Soul Sky smiled as he looked at Ning. "I was just about to go talk to you. Because of the trouble in the Waveshift realm?" Ning immediately asked. "You know about this as well?" Soul Sky was startled. "I just heard about this. Does this have anything to do with you, big brother?" Ning was rather worried. In truth, he was still just a Dao Lord of the second step, and he hadn't spent much time as a Dao Lord. Thus, the Brightshore Kingdom hadn't gone out of its way to inform him of this matter. And in truth, there really was no for them to do so. It was extremely difficult for Ning's world-level retainer to maintain contact with his clone located in the distant Brightshore Kingdom. "It does have a bit to do with me. To tell you the truth, Badlands and I were the ones who caused this." Soul Sky shook his head, a bitter smile on his face. "We ended up taking a beating, but didn't get any of the seals at all. Honestly, neither of us had really been expecting that we would. I was just hoping to get a heart shift pearl and use it to bolster my Dao merge chances. Why would have thought that we'd somehow cause the Void Sea Jade seals to emerge?" Soul Sky knew his own limits. Given that no one had been able to acquire the seals despite the passage of countless chaos cycles, how could he possibly hope for himself to acquire it? If he had to blame someone, the only one he could blame was Dao Lord Badlands for being absolutely incredible in numerancy. The latter had been able to find and solve some of the more critical questions before them, resulting in them activating the protections which Emperor Wave Shift had left behind. "No need to worry too much about this matter," Dao Lord Soul Sky said. "You have enough to worry about in the Terror Star Sea. Stay careful."
"Right.
Dark North, the Terror Star Sea is also quite a terrifying and dangerous place. Big Brother Soul Sky at least has Dao Lord Badlands' avatar helping him out. Given the latter's numerancy abilities, the two will be able to avoid much trouble." "It shouldn't be hard for them to avoid trouble," Dao Lord Battlemaster said. Ning let out a sigh of relief when he heard this.
"Right.
In terms of protecting others, even Ning himself probably wouldn't be useful as Badlands' avatar, the latter was simply too powerful in the Dao of Numerancy."
"Right.
Dark North." Dao Lord Battlemaster asked hurriedly, "When your big brother Soul Sky first headed to the Wave Shift realm, he didn't really try to hide it. As a result, Vast Heaven Palace will probably face some trouble. My true body will hide within Vast Heaven Palace alongside OU brothers. Will your avatar stay here or accompany us?"
"Wait, what's this about Vast Heaven Palace facing trouble?"
The Desolate Era. Chapter 18, Dao Lords Assemble. I should be the only Verge-level Dao Lord to have entered the Waveshift realm in recent memory. Dao Lord Soul Sky said heavily, "I didn't go out of my way to keep my trip a secret. Although not too many know about my trip, there are still a few Verge-level Dao Lords who know."
"The only one?"
Ji Ning's face turned pale. Dao Lord Soul Sky explained, "The Endless Territories have many dangerous locations within them, and the Waveshift realm holds very few treasures. There's nothing of real interest aside from the Void Sea Jade Seals, making it a much less enticing proposition than the Terror Star Sea. Ever since Emperor Waveshift departed, no one has ever been able to find so much as a single one of those seals. Thus, there are now very few Dao Lords who will brave the dangers of the Waveshift realm. I should be the only one to have gone inside in recent memory.
Then this is going to be trouble."
Ning nodded.
Everyone will be able to guess that someone inside the wave shift realm probably caused the enormous stir. If you are the only one who has gone inside lately, you are going to become everyone's target. Not just me. Even Badlands is going to be in trouble as well. Dalord Solsky shook his head. Dalord Solsky's prediction was frighteningly accurate. The Badlands court was indeed in trouble.
Boom!
A wicked black cloud descended upon the entire Badlands court. A black-robed woman stood at the center of that black cloud. Her skin was green, her eyes were crimson, and she had a pair of curved green horns on her head. She called out in an icy voice, "Badlands! Fellow Daoist Dust Rain!" An azure-robed man stood in front of the Badlands court. It was Dalord Badlands' avatar. An avatar? Are you actually going to send a mere avatar to meet with me? Fiend Queen Dustrain let out a cold snort. Dalord Dustrain was referred to as Fiend Queen due to her exceptional strength as well as the fact that she walked a devilish, demonic path. She was publicly acknowledged as the seventh most powerful Dalord of the Endless Territories. But of course, this ranking was only based on the Dalords who had revealed their strength to the outside world. There were many low-key ones who had not, and the outside world knew very little about them. For example, the Nine Dust Sect Lord was roughly on par with Dalord Dustrain, but very few people knew about him. "I'm quite sorry, but my true body has departed some time ago along with my wife for some sightseeing." Dalord Badlands' avatar swept the distant skies with his gaze. Fellow Daoist Dustrain and the other fellow Daoists off in the distance. "I know why all of you have come. The strange and incredible happenings within the wave shift realm are indeed related to me. However, I swear on my very life itself that neither I nor Dalord Solsky have acquired so much as a single Void Sea Jade Seal."
Huh.
Emperor Wave Shift plotted all this out in advance. There's no way he would have let us acquire them with such ease. If you wish to attack, feel free to go ahead and wipe out my avatar. However, I, Badlands, will make it known to all of you that if anyone actually dares to attack, I will repay you tenfold. His words complete, Dalord Badlands turned and headed right back into the Badlands court. He didn't so much as glance at the many Dalords who had arrived, nor did he pay any attention to Fiend Queen Dustrain in the skies. Humph, Fiend Queen Dustrain had an ugly look on her face, and the other Dalords off in the distance were all hesitating. They didn't fear death, but, if Badlands had already decided to ignore them, what were they supposed to do? There was no point in destroying his avatar, that would be a meaningless act. And, if Dalord Badlands really did elect on taking revenge, he would become a very frightening foe. This would be doubly true once he became a Dalord of the fourth step. By then, he would be the number one master of the Dao of Numerancy within the Endless Territories. Not even hegemons would be able to prevent him from taking revenge upon his foes. It seems that our only choice is to enter the wave shift realm. If we go in ahead of the others, our chances might be a bit higher. Fiend Queen Dustrain pondered for a moment within the skies, then turned and flew straight towards the wave shift realm. Although the Badlands court was located within the Badlands Everworld, given that Dalord Badlands had made his position clear and had left merely an avatar behind, there really was no one who chose to attack him. If his true body was here, he probably would have been captured long ago. But just an avatar. In the end, Dalord Badlands had a sufficiently fearsome reputation and was able to deter these people. Vast Heaven Palace, however, did not. "I just received word that Dalord Badlands has merely left his avatar to stand guard over the Badlands court. However, if anyone dares to attack the Badlands court, he will repay the attacker tenfold in the future." Two Dalords were chatting as they strode side by side through the void. A dimensional tunnel surrounded them, and they were walking straight through it with no need for a spacetime transfer array. That was a pretty nasty move. One of the Dalords was dressed in dark red armor. "It seems our only choice is to see if we can get any information from Dalord Solsky." The other Dalord was dressed in gray robes, and he let out a sigh. "We're quite close to the Vast Heaven territory. Given your mastery over the Dao of Space, Brother Soul Truth, we should be able to get there quite quickly.
In roughly 2 or so weeks, we should reach Vast Heaven Palace. We might even be the first ones there. The dark red armored Dao Lord said coldly, for the sake of the Dao merge, we have no choice but to employ unpleasant means against Vast Heaven Palace.
Agreed.
Dao Lord Soul Sky is the only Verge level Dao Lord who has entered as of late, and he certainly knows more about the Wave Shift realm than most. Even if he simply gives us an intelligence report regarding the place, it'll make our trip into the Wave Shift realm much simpler and our chances of acquiring the Void Sea Jade Seals much higher, the Grey Robe Dao Lord said. With so many Dao Lords heading to the Wave Shift realm, they really weren't confident in their own chances at all. There were far, far too many who were more powerful than them. However, if they were able to acquire some information in advance, they might have a shot.
A few days later.
We're about to reach Vast Heaven Palace, the Grey Robe Dao Lord Soul Truth said.
Vast Heaven Palace, a flicker of cold light flashed through the dark red armored Dao Lord's eyes. They would force the information out of Soul Sky, no matter what they had to do. The weather was clear this day, and the skies were like an enormous, beautiful bowl of azure porcelain. The wind was blowing through this world, and two figures were slowly walking through the skies. They could already see Vast Heaven Palace up ahead.
We've reached Vast Heaven Palace.
The dark red armored Dao Lord was slightly excited.
Our best chances lie within Vast Heaven Palace.
Agreed.
The gray-robed Dao Lord nodded.
I'll go call him out.
I refuse to believe that old bastard would dare to refuse us.
A flicker of a murderous intent could be seen in the dark red armored Dao Lord's eyes.
They had come here to force Soul Sky to give them what they wanted.
Solaski. After having flown slightly closer, the armored Dao Lord let out a loud call that echoed within the heavens, causing an invisible but baleful aura to spread outwards from him and cover the entire Vast Heaven Palace.
Solaski.
Get out here.
Within a palace courtyard.
Ning, Soul Sky, Battlemaster, and Brightfish were all present.
All four of them had only left their avatars behind, and the vast majority of the Vast Heaven Palace's disciples had departed already.
The only ones left behind were some disciples who had many clones, as well as a few servants.
Soul Sky.
Get out here.
A loud bellow rang out from outside.
Here they come.
Dao Lord Soul Sky let out a cold snort.
So someone has finally arrived.
Ning, Battlemaster, and Brightfish all had mixed looks on their faces.
They had predicted long ago that trouble was coming for Vast Heaven Palace, as there would definitely be some Dao Lords who would come for Dao Lord Soul Sky.
In addition, some were located fairly close by.
Some would move quickly while others would move more slowly, but in the end there would be many batches of them.
Clearly, the first batch of Dao Lords had arrived.
Let's go take a look and see who it is.
Dao Lord Soul Sky arose and walked outside, with Ning, Battlemaster, and Brightfish following behind him.
Whoosh.
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 All four Dao Lord avatars flew out into the skies, remaining within the protective embrace of Vast Heaven Palace as they stared at the two distant figures.
That's Dao Lord Soul Truth and Dao Lord Mistbearer.
Dao Lord Solaski's face tightened slightly as he sent mentally to the other three,
Dao Lord Soul Truth is skilled in the Dao of Space and is an extremely troublesome foe, while Dao Lord Mistbearer is sealed in close combat.
These two are both on par with me.
Ning understood.
These two Dao Lords weren't all that powerful, they were merely on the same level as Soul Sky and Patriarch Clearwind.
The weaker ones wouldn't even try to come here, while there were only a few strong ones, they would need time to make it here.
Soul Truth.
Mistbearer.
Why have you two come to Vast Heaven Palace?
Dao Lord Soul Sky barked.
Stop pretending.
Are you trying to tell me that you don't know why we are here?
The distant dark red armored Dao Lord Mistbearer let out an angry snarl.
Is it about the Wave Shift realm?
Dao Lord Soul Sky said, I can swear a lifeblood oath that I do not have any Void Sea Jade Seals right now.
I guessed as much.
Dao Lord Mistbearer smirked.
There's no way the Jade Seals left behind by Emperor Wave Shift would be obtained so easily.
However,
I need all of the information you know regarding the wave shift realm.
So long as you provide that to us, the two of us will leave immediately.
Dalord Solsky let out a cold snort.
That's a nice dream you are having.
Do the two of you really think you have what it takes?
He and Dalord Badlands had spent many tens of thousands of years braving the dangers of that place and searching laboriously for as much information they could find.
It was all thanks to Dalord Badlands' repeated usage of numerancy divination that Hay had learned so many of the secrets of the wave shift realm.
How could they just send this information out to others?
This is an item we acquired last time we adventured through the Terror Star Sea.
The distant Dalord Mistbearer produced a strange stone globe that was covered with many complex runes that faintly emanated a terrifying aura of power.
If I crush this item, I'll be able to annihilate the entire Vast Heaven Palace.
If you refuse to give me the information I need, I'll have no choice but to use it.
Speak.
The gray-robed Dalord said coldly, will you give us the information or not?
The Desolate Era.
Chapter 19, For the Dao Merge.
What?
The Dalords of Vast Heaven Palace, including Ji Ning, Dalord Battlemaster, Dalord Solsky, and Dalord Brightfish were all shocked.
They stared intently at the stone globe held in the hands of Dalord Mistbearer.
All of them could sense the faint aura of terrifying power emanating from the stone globe.
This Dalord Mistbearer actually has an item like this?
Dalord Solsky and the others turned pale.
There were actually quite a number of Dao seals and other strange curios which had been created by Eternal Emperors and had slowly accumulated over time.
This was particularly true for the Terror Star Sea, which had been the battlefield of the Dawn War.
There were many, many treasures there that were capable of unleashing terrifying levels of power.
However, acquiring these treasures was quite difficult.
Most Dao Lords of the Fourth Step did not have access to such treasures.
Dao Lords on the level of Solsky, Patriarch Clearwind, and Dao Lord Mistbearer had been alive for quite some time.
If they dared to go out adventuring and live to tell the tale, they would generally end up with one or two of them.
Experts on the level of Kong San had been alive for even longer.
They would generally have 9 or 10 such items on them.
As for the likes of King Gorsh or Palace Lord Dawnstar, the most powerful of Dao Lords?
They were capable of slaying ordinary Eternal Emperors with ease.
A casual blow from them was more than enough to annihilate Vast Heaven Palace and held as much power as those strange artifacts and Dao seals.
Thus, those things were of very little use to them.
Only precious hegemon created items were of interest and use to them, but those were incredibly rare.
These curios were divided into many different types, such as defensive, fleeing, karmic, illusory, offensive, and more.
Dalord Mistbearer actually has a treasure meant for attacking.
Dalord Solsky was rather anxious now.
This treasure is very important to Dalord Mistbearer.
The handsome Dalord Brightfish sent mentally, but for the sake of the Dao Merge, he's gone berserk.
He really would be willing to use this treasure up.
Everyone, what should we do?
Let me give it a try first, Dalord Battlemaster said.
The four Dalords of Vast Heaven Palace stared at the two enemy Dalords.
Fellow Daoists.
Dalord Battlemaster called out in a loud voice, I imagine you have also received word that Dalord Badlands has left the Badlands court long ago.
Vast Heaven Palace isn't staffed by fools either, our brothers have also left long ago.
The four of us are merely avatars.
Even if you use up that treasure and destroy Vast Heaven Palace, you'd at most be able to destroy our avatars.
We're more than capable of enduring such minor losses.
Dalord Mistbearer and Dalord Soultruth radiated surging, murderous auras from their position in the skies.
Dalord Mistbearer said coldly, the creation of Vast Heaven Palace involved you spending enormous amounts of effort in setting up its protective formations.
The materials needed to create four avatars were also extremely costly, not to mention the time spent in nurturing them.
Would you really just give them up like that?
For the sake of the Dao Merge, we are indeed willing to give them all up.
Dalord Battlemaster smiled.
I have an idea.
Let us have both sides take a step back.
The distant Dalord Mistbearer and Dalord Soultruth exchanged a glance.
Speak.
Dalord Mistbearer commanded coldly.
Vast Heaven Palace is willing to hand over an intelligence report containing information regarding the Wave Shift realm, Dalord Battlemaster said. While it won't include everything Big Brother Soul Sky knows, it'll still be far more than what the rest of the universe knows about the Waveshift realm. What do you think? If the two of you accept, we'll give you the report right away. It has to include everything Dalord Soul Sky knows. Dalord Mistbearer shouted coldly. As his voice boomed out, an infinitely vast wave of blood appeared out of nowhere, sweeping through the skies and surrounding the entirety of Vast Heaven Palace. Dalord Mistbearer's murderous aura flared as he roared, "If you refuse, die." Soul Sky, stop struggling, Dalord Soul Truth barked as well. "You are going too far." Dalord Battlemaster said coldly, "My big brother and Dalord Badlands experienced countless travails in order to find this information. You want them to hand it all over? Impossible. Do you take the two of us for fools?" Emperor Waveshift was the creator of the Waveshift realm. He was and remains the most skilled expert in the Tao of the Numerancy the Endless Territories has ever seen. The Waveshift realm is filled with many dangers and is incredibly complex. If you just give us a portion of your information, it'll be of negligible use to us. Dalord Soultruth said coldly, "Battlemaster, stop playing games with us. We aren't fools. You have two options before you. To hand it over, or to not hand it over. I will claim the life of anyone who dares to bar my Tao merge." The distant Tao Lord Mistbearer raised the stone globe up high with one hand, his voice filled with murder. "I'll give you 3 seconds to consider this. If you refuse, I'll wipe you out. 3, 2. Dalord Mistbearer stood there in the skies, surrounded by endless surging waves of blood, the stone globe held up high and flaring in one final warning. For the sake of the Tao merge, he wouldn't show any mercy at all. But, Soul Sky, Battlemaster, and Brightfish all turned pale. As for Ning, he had a complex look on his face. "Everyone shares the same concern, the Tao merge. Why must we be like this? This stroke of Daemerge-related fortune belongs to my big brother. Today, you come to pressure him, tomorrow, others will do the same. Are we to repeatedly give way and just hand this opportunity over to others?" Ning shook his head. "You two should leave. If you refuse to leave, I'll have no choice but to attack." "Attack?" The two distant Tao lords were both startled. Ning's face gradually turned cold. "Leave." The faces of the two distant Tao lords turned grim. They were slowly beginning to sense the threat that Ning posed them. Previously, Ning had not yet wished them dead, but now that he did, the sense of danger radiating from him grew significantly stronger. Ning's avatar was roughly on par with them. If his true body was here, the sense of danger would have been much stronger. "No one can bar my path to the Tao merge." Dalord Mistbearer and Dalord Soultruth shared a glance, but neither hesitated. "Hand over the report or prepare to do battle." Dalord Mistbearer roared. A flicker of a murderous light flashed through Ning's cold eyes. An invisible surge of power instantly sprang out, separating into two streams that smashed directly against the souls and the true souls of the two Dalords. Heart Force Eradicator. This, a hint of terror and disbelief flashed through Dalord Mistbearer's eyes before his gaze turned completely dull and lifeless. His corpse began to fall down from the skies. "He's a Heart Force cultivator." The gray-robed Dalord Soltruth's face turned bone white, but he was able to endure the Heart Force Eradicator attack. He stared at Ning in horror. That Heart Force attack had been absolutely terrifying. It was only thanks to his strong Tao heart that he had managed to survive. However, he knew that Heart Force cultivators possessed many strange and unpredictable techniques, and they didn't really rely on such brutish attacks. They primarily relied on illusions and bewildering spells, and if this Daelord's brute force attacks were already this powerful, how devilish would his illusions be? Even an instant of distraction could very well prove fatal. "Hurry up and flee." Dalord Soultruth no longer cared about anything else. He hurriedly waved his hand. Whoosh!
A dazzling rainbow-dimensional tunnel instantly appeared next to him, and he hurriedly dove into it and began to flee. A tear in space appeared within a region of primordial chaos more than 20 territories away. Moments later, the gray-robed and rather bedraggled-looking Daolord Soultruth jumped out of it, a stunned look on his face. He's actually a Heart Force cultivator. The newest Daolord of Vast Heaven Palace, Daolord Dark North, a completely unremarkable person I've heard almost nothing about, is actually a Heart Force cultivator. And a terrifyingly strong one at that. He was able to kill Brother Mistbearer with a thought. Ugh. Brother Mistbearer's Dao Heart was rather lacking, due to his excessively murderous impulses. I never would have imagined that the most powerful member of Vast Heaven Palace would be Daolord Dark North, rather than Daolord Soul Sky. Daolord Soultruth let out a soft sigh. Things are going to be complicated now. Everyone thought that Vast Heaven Palace would be easy to deal with, but who would have thought such a terrifying figure would exist within it? Everyone agreed that Heart Force cultivators were notoriously difficult to deal with. Unless absolutely necessary, no one would willingly make an enemy out of one. Outside Vast Heaven Palace. The corpse of Daolord Mistbearer continued its descent through the skies. As for Daolord Soul Sky, Battlemaster, and Brightfish, all three of them stared at Ning in disbelief. All this is due to the Dao Merge, Ning shook his head, then waved his hand and collected the falling corpse of Daolord Mistbearer. Ning then turned around, only to see the other three staring straight at him. Something wrong? I'm just collecting his corpse. We can split the treasures later, Ning grinned. Stop joking. Daolord Soulsky flew straight towards Ning, then grabbed him by the shoulders. Gee Ning, why you are a Heart Force cultivator? Right. You are actually a Heart Force cultivator? Battlemaster and Brightfish were quite excited as well. Yes. Ning nodded. Right. Previously, I've been spending all my attention on strengthening my avatar. As soon as I left seclusion, this happened. I didn't even have a chance to talk to any of you. However, better late than never. Not late. Not late at all. Daolord Brightfish was quite excited. I never imagined that Vast Heaven Palace would produce a Heart Force cultivator. Huh. Who in the outside world would dare to belittle us in the future? I always thought that you were a genius of the Dao of the Sword. Daolord Soulsky stared intently at Ning, also quite excited. I never would have imagined that you'd actually be a Heart Force cultivator, and that you'd be even more formidable in this area than you are in the Dao of the Sword. You slew Daolord Mistbearer with just a glance. Ning couldn't help but say, actually, my sword Dao is slightly stronger than my Heart Force. The Desolate Era. Chapter 20, Daolord Darknortha's Name. Your sword Dao is stronger than your Heart Force? Daolord Soulsky stared at Ji Ning in astonishment. He couldn't help but ask, Ji Ning, what level have you reached, exactly? I might not be able to beat the most powerful Dao Lords, but escaping them should be no problem at all, Ning said. In truth, Ning now stood at the very peak of power amongst second-tier Dao Lords. He was now much stronger than Kong San had ever been. Even if he fought against first-tier Dao Lords like King Gorsh, he might win if their Dao Hearts were weak. If their Dao Hearts were weak and they were trapped by his illusions, then he would have a chance of beating them as well. However, the vast majority of Supreme Dao Lords had extremely powerful Dao Hearts, and so he would be unable to do anything to most of them. Still, Ning had his hegemon armor and was extremely skilled at staying alive. He also had his nine novescence arts, his heart world projection, his ability to transcend space, and more. There really were few to know Dao Lords who could do anything to him. But, Daolord Soulsky was rather flabbergasted. Dark North, how did you suddenly become a Heart Force cultivator? Daolord Battlemaster was quite curious. Early on as a cultivator, I actually improved even more quickly in Heart Force than I did in the Dao of the Sword. A reminiscent look was in Ning's eyes. Afterwards, some events cast a shadow over my heart, resulting in me being unable to improve my Heart Force at all. This time, I had some lucky encounters and was able to break through in Heart Force and establish a Heart World.
As a result, my heart world naturally began to expand and grow, allowing me to reach my current level of power. A master of both the sword Dao and heart force.
Impressive, truly impressive, Daolord Brightfish said as he sighed in amazement.
Heart force cultivators were famous for their bizarre, nerve-wracking techniques. If a heart force cultivator was also skilled in close combat, he'd become absolutely terrifying to deal with. This was just the type of person Ning was.
Oh, right. Dark North, why did you release Daolord Soul Truth just now?
Daolord Brightfish quickly added, I could vaguely sense that you only attacked a single time, and you didn't use any illusions at all.
Right.
Ning nodded. Since he was able to survive my Heart Force Eradicator, I decided to spare his life. He'll definitely go tell his Verge-level friends about what happened today and warn them, and those friends will in turn warn their own friends. Thus, word will quickly spread, ensuring that the vast majority of Verge-level Daolords will know better than to come here and cause trouble.
Ji Ning's choice was correct.
We can't be forced to deal with one Daolord troublemaker after another, Daolord Soulsky said.
Dark North.
Battlemaster said worriedly, the vast majority of Daolords might be too scared to come, but those who do dare to come will be tough to deal with.
Then I'll simply kill them.
A murderous light flashed through Ning's eyes.
We'll see who is stronger.
Ning still felt quite confident in his chances. His Daolord avatar was a key refiner, a fiend god refiner, and a heart force cultivator. He was able to use divine abilities and secret arts. However, Ning realized that there was no way to duplicate his 9 chaos seals upon his avatar, and his avatar only contained an extremely small part of his soul. This was why his avatar was still significantly weaker than his true body. Any living being's core essence came from his soul and true soul. If the soul or true soul was extinguished, the cultivator would die. Generally speaking, if your soul and true soul were weak, the amount of divine power, immortal energy, and heart force in your body would also be correspondingly weak. It would be very hard for you to remain in top condition. Thus, you needed to stay in contact with your true body's soul and ensure that both souls were nurtured. This was the reason why Daolords generally would at most maintain a single avatar at any point in time. It wasn't easy keeping an avatar's soul in peak condition, and it was quite time-consuming as well. But of course, if you had a primal twin, you would be able to maintain a second avatar. Ning had both a true body and a primal twin, and his primal twin's soul was just as strong as his true body's. Both souls were inextricably linked. However, Ning chose to only maintain a single avatar, using both his true body and his primal twin's souls to nurture it. As a result, Ning's avatar was comparatively more powerful than that of most Daolord avatars. If the Northbow swords were excluded from the equation, his avatar was roughly 70% as strong as his true body. His avatar held other advantages as well. Avatars were created from magic treasures that were covered with formations, and they could be infused with prime essences just like lifeblood treasures. Ning's avatar contained the essence of his Omega Sword Dao, and the special properties which all avatars had ensured that he was able to perfectly link up with the local formations and become part of them. When reinforced by those formations, his power was comparable to that of his true body. This was the reason why many Daolords had their avatars stand guard over their homes. Ning's predictions were spot on. After fleeing for his life, Daolord Soultruth did indeed warn his best friends, who in turn warned their best friends. Word quickly spread at a viral rate, and both Vastheaven Palace and the Badlands Court became centers of attention for the countless Daolords of the Endless Territories. Daolord Badlands of the Badlands Court had gone into hiding with his wife. Nobody could find them. The only chance the comparatively weaker Daolords had lay in Vastheaven Palace.
What?
A heart force cultivator? He was able to slay Daolord Mistbearer from afar with but a thought? Daolord Soultruth was just barely able to stay alive? His avatar alone is already that powerful? What's the name of this terrifying heart force cultivator of Vastheaven Palace?
Dark North.
His name is Dark North. Word quickly began to spread. When Ning had slain Kong San,
he hadn't gone out of his way to reveal himself, and so there really were very few who knew that he was the killer. As a result, he had little to no reputation in the endless territories. However, the incredible results he had displayed with merely an avatar instantly shocked countless Dao Lords. He hadn't even really fought. He had wiped out Dao Lord Mistbearer with but a casual look. This battle brought him instant fame. Finally, Ning had become truly famous within the endless territories. Countless Dao Lords now knew of a terrifying Heart Force cultivator known as Dao Lord Dark North. An ordinary chaos world. An ordinary mortal city. Dao Lord Badlands and his wife were living within a mountain villa inside this city, living a relaxed life. What's that? Dao Lord Dark North has become a Heart Force cultivator? He wiped out Dao Lord Mistbearer with just his avatar. Dao Lord Badlands had been sipping wine in a leisurely manner, but he suddenly revealed a shocked look on his face. What did you just say, husband? Dao Lord Dark North? His beautiful wife was shocked as well. Yes, Dao Lord Dark North. Remember him? The Ji Ning kid who once stayed in our Badlands court for a short period of time? As I recall, when he arrived in the Badlands court he was merely an elder god. Only after returning from the all-god estate did he become a world-level cultivator. It feels like it was just yesterday that he was at the world level. Now, he's actually able to wipe out the likes of Dao Lord Mistbearer with a thought while just using his avatar? He's definitely much more powerful than I am. Dao Lord Badlands was quite stunned. He was skilled in numerancy, but numerancy didn't confer omniscience upon him. The more talented and powerful a cultivator was, the harder it would be to divine his fate. If his avatar is already this powerful, how impressive must his true body be? His wife was stunned as well. He's reached such incredible levels of power despite having trained for a very short period of time. In the future, he will most assuredly become one of the most supreme Dao Lords of all the endless territories. Even today, there are no Dao Lords who would dare to underestimate him. Dao Lord Badlands shook his head. Because, he is a Heart Force cultivator. The Brightshore Kingdom's intelligence network was similarly quick, and word quickly spread to them as well. The 12 palaces of the Brightshore Kingdom were filled with commotion as well. Dao Lord Dark North of the Sword Palace has ended up becoming a Heart Force cultivator? From what I've heard, his Sword Dao is incredibly powerful. How is it that he became so formidable in Heart Force as well? Dao Lord Soulwind of the Heart Force Palace might be extremely talented, but I don't think he's strong enough to use his avatar to wipe out Dao Lord Mistbearer with a thought. Dark North has become a Heart Force cultivator? Prince Greatjoy had just returned to the Brightshore Kingdom when he heard this news. He revealed a hint of a smile on his face. Interesting. I never would have thought that of the four of us who went to the alternate universe, Dark North would end up taking the lead. It seems I need to work even harder. Beneath the leaves of a strange, fiery red tree that was more than 10 million kilometers tall sat a skinny bald youth. The youth had a smile on his face, but his eyes were closed as he trained there silently. His upper body was covered with fiery red divine runes which seemed linked to the enormous flaming tree behind him. The runes would sometimes spread out while at other times clustering together. Soulwind opened his eyes, then smiled. Brother Dark North has actually become a Heart Force cultivator, and a powerful one at that? I had thought that I was doing fairly well for myself, after having created a secret art comparable to the Featherdress Soulthrall song. I didn't expect that Brother Dark North would not only become a Heart Force cultivator but become even more powerful than me in this area. Soulwind was actually incredibly talented in Heart Force. When he had been at the world level, he had been on par with monstrously talented figures like Greatjoy and Ji Ning. After becoming a Dao Lord, he would be able to easily reach the verge and become one of the most powerful of Heart Force cultivators. In the Genesis Lands, he had acquired a legacy left behind by a Heart Force hegemon. He naturally had an extraordinary destiny ahead of him, and he had already created a secret art that was on par with the Featherdress Soulthrall song. Although he had only created the early stages of it, his foundation was already quite solid. The more solid your foundation was, the slower and steadier your training would be.
At present, Soulwind was also just a Daolord of the second step.
No. No way. Impossible. How can he be this much more powerful than me?
Fire Surge was located within a tattered shrine, and he was bellowing with rage.
Impossible. I've been working so hard. Why is it that he's pulling farther and farther away from me?
Of the four peerless geniuses who had visited the alternate universe, Fire Surge had the weakest mind and Daoheart. He had always felt certain that he would become the strongest, and had been working hard this entire time. He was now quite powerful, but Dark North, a master of the Dao of the Sword, had somehow ended up becoming a Heart Force cultivator, and reached incredibly terrifying heights in Heart Force at that. The news quickly spread throughout the universe, and everyone had a different reaction to it. Ning's primary goal was achieved, the vast majority of Dao Lords shrank back. Very, very few had the courage and confidence needed to fight a Heart Force cultivator. This is a 7 English podcast and you're listening to an adventure fantasy novel. The Desolate Era. Book 31, Starflow Realm. Chapter 21, Sincerity. A dimensional rift appeared within a region which bordered both the Endless Territories and the Terror Star Sea. Two figures emerged from it, one a white-robed youth who carried a golden sheath on his back, the second an insidious-looking silver-robed man who radiated an aura of power.
We finally made it.
Huh, I didn't expect things would progress this smoothly. Ji Ning and the Nine Dust Sect Lord both sighed in amazement. The two of us were so worried about dying at first. The Nine Dust Sect Lord laughed. Thank goodness Patriarch Volturas gave us that star map, and thank goodness your sword arts have transcended space, Dark North. And thank goodness you are also a Heart Force cultivator. We also need to celebrate our good fortune. The Starflow River was supposed to be the most dangerous part of the journey, but we were so lucky that we didn't run into anything dangerous at all, Ning sighed happily. Their good luck had combined with many other factors, allowing them to survive their return to the Endless Territories.
Come, come. We need to make haste.
We wasted 60 years after leaving Thundersouth Palace, and we're still quite far from the Waveshift Realm. We've already wasted so much time, and if we waste any more the Void Sea Jade Seals will probably end up being taken by those who arrived early on, the Nine Dust Sect Lord said.
No rush, Ning said.
I have a very quick way of traveling straight to the Wave Shift Realm.
A very quick way?
The Nine Dust Sect Lord stared at Ning, puzzled. Through the space-time tunnels of the Brightshore Kingdom. Ning immediately added, Brother Nine Dust, I never spoke to you about this, but, although I am a member of the Dao Alliance, as a world-level cultivator I was abducted to the Brightshore Kingdom. Thus, I'm a member of the 12 Palaces of Brightshore.
The Brightshore Kingdom?
You belong to them?
The Nine Dust Sect Lord was stunned.
Yes. Ning nodded. Their journey back from the Terror Star Sea had been a dangerous one, with life-threatening situations possibly occurring at any moment. In order to avoid any mistrust and anything that could affect their ability to work together, Ning had stayed silent this entire time about his true status. Now that they had shared so many life and death experiences for so long, he truly didn't wish to keep this hidden.
Why you, the Nine Dust Sect Lord had a rather complicated look on his face.
He then let out a helpless sigh. Thankfully you are merely a member of the 12 Palaces. If you were a member of the Brightshore Imperials, I'd really have no clue what to do. The Brightshore Imperials have always been enemies of us ancient cultivators. We've been fighting each other for countless chaos cycles. Ning nodded. The Brightshore Imperials had once been the slaves of the ancient cultivators, which they viewed as the greatest stain on their honor. It wasn't at all odd that the successive generations of Brightshore Imperials had all viewed the ancient cultivators as their enemies. The Brightshore hegemon is absolutely shameless. The Nine Dust Sect Lord gritted his teeth, hard.
Of the three hegemons, he's the most shameless. He relies on his incredible mastery over spacetime to abduct some of the most powerful world-level cultivators of the Endless Territories. If it wasn't for the 12 Palaces of Brightshore, the Brightshore Kingdom wouldn't have the status and standing it currently does.
Ning had to acknowledge this as being true.
In terms of Dao Lords, the 12 palaces of Brightshore had far more members than the Brightshore Imperials. The 12 palaces often numbered one or more of the top three Dao Lords of each era within their ranks, and they even had eternal emperors. By comparison, the Imperial clan was much weaker. "It doesn't matter. You remain a brother for life," the Nine Dust Sect Lord declared. "And given my current level of power, I really don't worry about those Brightshore Imperials at all."
"Don't worry. I won't make things difficult for you."
Ning immediately let out a sigh of relief. If Nine Dust ended up in a battle against the Brightshore Imperials, the lifeblood oath Ning had sworn would force him to protect the Brightshore Imperials. Nine Dust was making his position clear in order to avoid precisely this type of awkward situation. Indeed, given Nine Dust standing at the very peak of power amongst Dao Lords, there really were few to no Brightshore Imperials who were a match for him, and not a single one who could truly threaten him. Now that he was a Dao Lord of the fourth step, the Nine Dust Sectlord's invulnerable aqua form was far more powerful than Kongsan's darkness incarnate form had been. In a normal battle, no Dao Lord was capable of annihilating him when he assumed that form. In truth, all of the most supreme Dao Lords had their own special talents, and all of them were generally quite hard to deal with. The only ones capable of threatening them were the most supreme of Heart Force Dao Lords, who were able to use techniques that struck at their very souls and true souls. Those attacks still proved dangerous to them. Dao Lord Featherdress had created the Featherdress Soul Thrall song, and become acknowledged as the most powerful of Dao Lords. The other supreme Dao Lords were unwilling to fight against her precisely because of her Heart Force abilities.
"Thank you, Nine Dust," Ning said gratefully.
"Cut that out.
We are brothers."
The Nine Dust Sect Lord shook his head and smiled. After having traveled with Ning for so long, he truly felt that Ning was a person worthy of being his lifelong friend. "Dark North, you spoke of using the Brightshore Kingdom space-time tunnels. Given who I am, it probably wouldn't be easy for me to enter them. When we get there, I'll have to trouble you to hide within one of my estate worlds for a time," Ning said.
"All right."
The Nine Dust Sect Lord nodded. The two were very close to each other, and they both naturally swore lifeblood oaths after having decided to go to the Waveshift realm together. Even the best of friends would generally rely on lifeblood oaths to bind each other, as it was possible for even lifelong brothers to turn on each other for the sake of treasures involving the Dao Merge. To avoid such disastrous outcomes, most would rely upon lifeblood oaths to keep everyone honest. As Ning and Nine Dust were hastening to the Waveshift realm, yet another danger befell Vastheaven Palace.
Vastheaven Palace.
A white-robed elder had just arrived at the Vastheaven Everworld. He stood at the peak of a mountain, staring at the distant Vastheaven Palace.
"I hear that Vastheaven Palace has gained a Heart Force cultivator."
A look of absolute self-confidence was in the white-robed elder's eyes. Due to certain choices he had made in his path of cultivation, he didn't fear Heart Force cultivators at all.
"My home was too far away from the Waveshift realm. I'm definitely going to arrive much later than the other Dao Lords. If I can procure the information regarding the Waveshift realm which Dao Lord Soulsky has, I might be able to acquire one of those jade seals even though I'll arrive later than the others."
The white-robed elder strode forwards through the skies, each step causing ripples of light to spread out. Soon, he arrived in the skies above Vastheaven Palace.
"Dark North.
Soulsky. Are you present?" the white-robed elder asked calmly. "Rumble," his voice echoed within the skies around the area. A short while later, four figures flew out of Vastheaven Palace. It was Ji Ning, Dao Lord Soulsky, Dao Lord Battlemaster, and Dao Lord Brightfish.
"All avatars."
The white-robed elder glanced at them, then shook his head and frowned. Avatars were disposable. Each one represented 10 million cubes of chaos nectar and quite a bit of effort, but for the sake of the Dao Merge, even fairly poor Dao Lords like Soulsky and Battlemaster would just grit their teeth and bear it.
"Him? The Junior Radiant King?"
Dao Lord Soliski's face turned white.
"It's actually him."
The faces of Ning and the others turned pale as well. Amongst the supreme Dao Lords of the Endless Territories,
there was a particularly powerful Dao Lord who had been given the respectful title of the Radiant King. He was a terrifying Dao Lord who was ranked third in the Endless Territories. As for the Junior Radiant King, he belonged to the same race as the Radiant King but was slightly weaker, ranking amongst the second-tier Dao Lords. However, he stood at the very peak of power amongst the second-tier Dao Lords and was considerably stronger than Kong San. The two of them belonged to the same race and used similar techniques. The Junior Radiant King's true Daoist title was actually Yanmi. He could thus be addressed as Dao Lord Yanmi, but most simply referred to him as the Junior Radiant King. "I'm sure you know that my heart is like light itself. You will be unable to shake my heart unless your heart force skills have reached a truly unfathomable peak," the white-robed elder said calmly. "For me, wiping out Vast Heaven Palace is a very easy task. Soul Sky, I imagine you know why I am here. Give me everything you know about the Waveshift Realm, or I will have no choice but to attack." Dao Lord Soul Sky had an ugly look on his face. Battlemaster and Brightfish were both anxious as well. They had guessed long ago that the power Ning had displayed was enough to scare off the vast majority of Dao Lords, but this concerned the Void Sea Jade Seals. Perhaps the Supreme Dao Lords who were completely confident in their abilities would head straight to the Waveshift Realm, but the ones who were slightly less confident would all come here to try their luck. And indeed, it was a matter of trying their luck. Everyone knew that the chances of Soul Sky handing the information over was quite low, but for the sake of the Dao Merge, they would still give it a try, no matter how low their chances were. "Humph," seeing the looks on the faces of the four, the white-robed elder let out a cold snort. Whoosh! He suddenly seemed transformed into a dazzling sun that radiated eye-piercing radiance. His light stretched out into infinity as multiple clones of him seemed to appear. Countless clones of him quickly filled the skies, resulting in what seemed like trillions of white-robed elders appearing above and surrounding the four Vast Heaven Dao Lords. "If you don't hand the information over, I'll have no choice but to wipe you out and destroy Vast Heaven Palace." The trillions of white-robed old men all spoke out at the same time, their voices booming in the skies. "Dao Lord Yanmi, if you wish to wipe out Vast Heaven Palace, you need to ask me for permission first." Ji Ning's cold voice rang out in response. The Desolate Era. Chapter 22, A Clash. The countless white-robed elders standing in midair all turned to stare directly at Ji Ning. "Dao Lord Dark North?" The countless white-robed elders smirked. "I've heard long ago that the newest Dao Lord of Vast Heaven Palace, Dao Lord Dark North, is an incredible figure who is also a Heart Force cultivator. Then, let me see just how much ability you have, Dao Lord Dark North. I have countless clones right now. Are you able to find the real me?" "Humph," Ning let out a cold snort. Boom! The surrounding area of countless kilometers around began to tremble and rumble as an enormous illusion of a world manifested above. This vast world had valleys, rivers, seas, mountains, and an extremely prominent and utterly enormous sword-shaped mountain at the very center of it. The enormous heart world projection came crashing straight down. The countless mountains in the surrounding area were instantly crushed into dust, almost as though an enormous hand had just slapped down upon them. The heart world projection had descended. The countless white-robed elders who had been glowing with light were also put under incredible pressure. Ning's heart world projection was on par with his nine novescence arts and possessed incredible power. One white-robed elder after another disappeared like popping bubbles, and soon a mere 529 white-robed elders remained in the skies. "What?" Looks of astonishment appeared simultaneously upon the faces of the remaining 529 elders. "What a powerful heart world projection!" The power of a heart world projection was a testament to the power of a cultivator's heart world. The greater the heart world, the stronger the projection. Ning's powerful heart world projection was incredible even amongst heart force cultivators, he could be considered as having reached the second tier. He's actually managed to keep a few clones active. Ning swept the 529 white-robed elders with his gaze. The Junior Radiant King lives up to his reputation. If the Radiant King himself was present, you wouldn't be able to wipe out a single one of his clones, the many white-robed elders smirked.
Perhaps. As Ning's words came out, his heart force swept out yet again. It lashed out like a wave towards the hundreds of white-robed elders, only to discover that every single one of them stood in the path of this wave. Clearly, every single white-robed elder contained part of the old man's soul and true soul.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
Heart Force Eradicator. Ning's heart force crashed directly against the soul and true soul of the white-robed elder. Impressive. However, you won't be able to do anything to me. Prepare to receive my blow. The many white-robed elders all waved their hands, causing a total of 9 black swords to appear in the skies. Big brother, stay far away from me, Ning warned mentally. Understood. Be careful and don't be reckless. Daolord Soulsky, Brightfish, and Battlemaster all quickly retreated. All of them felt nervous. This was going to be a dangerous battle. If Ning's true body was here, he would probably be able to win with ease, but he only had an avatar which had 70% of his true power, and most importantly of all, he didn't have the Northbow swords. Ever since those swords had drained so much golden sand from the shattered core of that planet, they had evolved to reach a terrifying level of power. The white-robed elders all separated as the 9 black swords appeared in the skies. Which one is the real one? Ning was quite puzzled. Without question, the true body was amongst the 529 and was controlling those 9 divine black swords. Unable to find my true body? Feeling a bit anxious? Huh, I'm able to maintain more than 500 clones, and you won't know which one to attack. That's why it is guaranteed that you will lose this fight. The hundreds of white-robed elders all laughed and then roared, "Kill!" Instantly, the 9 divine black swords in the skies transformed into 9 dark streaks of light, or to be precise, they transformed into 9 black strands of silk. They moved at incredible speeds, at least 59 times the speed of light. And this was with them being pressured by the heart world projection. Otherwise, they would strike even faster. According to the stories, the true Radiant King's flying speed alone had already surpassed the limit of 100 times the speed of light. The junior Radiant King was naturally somewhat inferior in comparison. I'm able to attack you, but you aren't able to attack me. You lost this battle before it ever began, huh? The many white-robed elders all laughed loudly. Go. Ning stood there calmly despite facing the 9 attacking black threads. Whoosh. Whoosh. Streams of sword intent began to manifest in the area around him. All of them began to tangle together like a group of fish, instantly forming an enormous vortex world of yin and yang. This enormous yin-yang world was centered around Ning, forcing any and all attacks to go through it first. This was Ning's yin-yang sword domain. However, it was formed purely out of sword intent and not his 9 novescence arts, and so they only had 20% of the power of the original.
Boom. 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 Boom.
The 9 black threads plunged directly into the yin-yang vortex world. Although they once more slowed down, they still quickly reached Ning. Fuck off. Ning let out a loud shout as he slapped out with both hands at once.
Kaboom.
His twin palms were like 2 enormous mountains slamming outwards as he manifested the Heavenbreaker sword intent of his Omega Sword Dao. His 2 palms were indescribably large and filled with overbearing brute force, but also moved in an unpredictable and marvelous way. The Omega Sword Dao was a perfect whole, after all, none of its stances, not even a brute force one like this, contained any stupid or clumsy weaknesses. Not only was this attack ferocious, it was also unpredictable and marvelous. The 9 black threads were unable to avoid it and so were forced to strike those 2 enormous palms head on.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
A series of explosions rang out as the 9 black swords were all knocked flying backwards. What? The many clones of the junior Radiant King all had looks of shock on their faces. My 9 swords are centered around the Tao of Light. They are incredibly fast and attacked from different directions, but none of them were able to avoid that attack. He could scarcely believe it. But of course, he had no idea that Ning's true skill lay in close combat,
thanks to his Tao of the Sword. The Tao of the Sword was meant for combat, and Ning was the master of the Omega Sword Tao. He had no flaws at all in close combat. Forget about 9 swords, even 99 or more swords would be unable to penetrate his airtight defenses. Ning hadn't even had to use his defensive soul heart stance in order to deal with those 9 swords, he had fought them head on. Clearly, they had posed no threat to him at all. Light shadow. A baleful look was in the junior Radiant King's eyes. Instantly, the 9 black swords in the skies transformed into a total of 320 black swords, every single one of which was able to endure the pressure of the heart world projection and survive. His heart world projection is incredibly strong. I'm normally able to manifest countless sword shadows, making my enemies unable to tell which are real and which are fake, but his heart world projection is making it so that I'm only able to manifest a bit over 300. The white-robed elders all stared intently at Ning. Try this a second time. Whoosh. 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 The 320 black swords transformed into black threads that once more shot towards Ning. This time, the old man spread them out even farther, making them attack Ning from every single direction, filling the area around Ning from head to toe with attacks. Ning stood there in the air. Faced with this omnipresent attack, he simply waved his palms again. Those two enormous palms struck out like two enormous wheels that merged together into a hole, defeating all of the attacking black swords and actually destroying a few of them. This was his Omega Sword Tao, Yin Yang. Although it was primarily a defensive stance, it did have some offensive power built into it. What? He withstood it all? The many white-robed elders were all shocked and enraged. Then I'll have no choice but to use my forbidden arts to kill him.
Boom.
The white-robed elders' many clones all shone brightly. Countless streams of light mixed together, causing the entire vast heaven everworld to be illuminated by them. This light was so dazzling to behold that it truly did light up every single corner of this entire everworld. The weaker cultivators of the vast heaven everworld all raised their heads to stare at the light in the skies, puzzled. He's going all out. Seeing this, Ning realized that the white-robed elder's repeated failures had caused him to feel so anxious as to go all out. Is he going to use the legendary Lumislayer? This was Ning's first guess. The legendary Radiant King was ranked 3rd amongst the Tao Lords of the Endless Territories, while Palace Lord Dawnstar was ranked 2nd. Both, however, were actually on par with each other in power. The Radiant King's fame in the Endless Territories came from his 3 supreme killing techniques, and not even ordinary Eternal Emperors would dare receive these 3 blows head-on. Vast Heaven Tao Lords watching in the distance all turned pale. Just what I wanted. Ning laughed loudly as he once more struck out with his palms. Whoosh. This time, an enormous black hole appeared in the area around Ning that swallowed up everything in its path.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
A series of muffled, heavy collisions could be heard, but the black hole around Ning didn't dissipate in the slightest. Ha. Is that all you have? Ning's loud laughter rang out throughout the world around them. What? Tao Lord Yanmi was shocked. Impossible. How could he have endured my attack that easily? Even if his avatar is comparable to top-grade eternal treasures, he should have been blown backwards and been completely unable to resist the power of my attack. His plan had been to knock Ning off his feet, then use his light to bind and tie down Ning during Ning's moment of helplessness. But Ning had actually taken his blow head-on. How can his avatar be as powerful as this? If his true body was here, would he be crushing me instead of vice versa? Tao Lord Yanmi could hardly believe it. This was one of the 3 killer attacks created by the Radiant King, the Lumislayer. Although this is the weakest of the 3 attacks, this result is still. All of the light vanished, and Ning's true body appeared once more. He stared at Tao Lord Yanmi, then shook his head. Tao Lord Yanmi, you truly have disappointed me. So this is the first of the 3 legendary killer attacks of the Radiant King? If the Radiant King himself used this Lumislayer, not even Eternal Emperors would dare to receive it head-on. But you are lacking by far.
Ning's Omega Sword Dao had reached the ultimate apex in both offense and defense. The only way to breach his defense would be through an overwhelming disparity in power. Clearly, although his avatar only had 70% of his true body's power, it was still roughly on par with Dao Lord Yanmi. He blocked it. Dao Lord Soul Sky let out a sigh of relief. Dark Northa's Sword Dao truly is on par with his heart force. He was actually able to endure the Lumis Layer with ease. Dao Lord Brightfish sighed in amazement. He truly is incredible. But the situation is still quite unfavorable for him. Dao Lord Battlemaster frowned. The Junior Radiant King has manifested over 500 clones. Dark North can do nothing but passively accept the man's attacks. There's no way for him to counterattack at all. None of his counterattacks would land on the Junior Radiant King's true body. Dao Lord Soul Sky nodded somberly as well. Yes. This is going to be a passive, one-sided battle. If he can't hit back, it won't be easy to win. According to what I've heard, the Junior Radiant King is able to use only the first two killer attacks of the three. Dao Lord Brightfish said anxiously, in comparison, the Lumis Layer is actually the weakest of the three attacks. Next is the Lumihilator, with the strongest being the legendary Lumapocalypse. Slay. Annihilate. Apocalypse. These were the three legendary killer attacks. According to the legends, the Lumapocalypse was created and practiced by the Radiant King alone. It was this technique which allowed him to be recognized and acknowledged as the third most powerful Dao Lord of all the Endless Territories. However, the principle of this attack was to first injure the self, then injure the foe. Ordinary Eternal Emperors would probably be slain in a single blow by this attack. One could imagine how strong it was. Given that even the Radiant King himself would be injured when using this attack, there was no way the Junior Radiant King, Dao Lord Yanmi, was qualified to use it. Is that so? Dao Lord Yanmi had an ugly look on his face, and he was verily brimming with murderous intent. I hear that you can use two of the three killer attacks of the Radiant King. I wonder how strong the second attack is? Ning's eyes gleamed with excitement. He wanted to see just how strong the so-called Lumihilator was and how it measured up to his own attacks, such as the Blood Drop Stance and the Shadowless Stance. The Radiant King himself normally just used the Lumihilator in combat, as the third killer attack would cause him severe injuries. Thus, he wouldn't use it without a very good reason. Then have a taste of annihilation for yourself. Dao Lord Yanmi's hundreds of clones suddenly all vanished into thin air. Whoosh. They dispersed into motes of light that reformed into a single Dao Lord Yanmi. Ning narrowed his eyes. I'm fairly weak, Dao Lord Yanmi said in a soft voice. Thus, I'm unable to maintain my clones while using the Lumihilator. The Radiant King, however, is able to launch this attack with all of his clones at once, making it impossible to tell which is real and which is false. That is true power. However, against you, my strength is enough. Ning immediately grew vigilant. Dao Lord Yanmi was done to just a single body now, and it didn't seem all that powerful, and it was precisely the fact that he had reserved all of his power that Ning felt all the more vigilant. Dao Lord Yanmi produced a single black sword in his hand. Annihilate, he murmured softly. Swoosh. His entire body seemed to merge together with that sword and transform into a dazzling strand of golden light. Even though he was under the pressure of the heart world projection and the Yin Yang sword domain, he still moved at 72 times the speed of light. What terrifying speed! Ning was stunned. He himself was far slower than his opponent. However, you wish to fight me in close combat? Humph, close combat isn't all about speed. Faced with the attacking strand of golden light, Ning struck out with both hands, forming sword fingers with them to block. Clang! 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 This power of this strand of golden light came from pure speed. Just as it started to clash against Ning's fingers and be blocked by them, it instantly changed directions. The strand of golden light continuously circled around Ning,
moving at terrifying speeds as it attacked him again and again, almost as if it was bouncing between multiple mirrors. Ning was forced to rely on his Omega Sword Dao, Soul Heart and pour all of his efforts into defense. How is this possible? How could his defenses be completely flawless? How can his avatar keep up with my speed? Dao Lord Yenmi was stunned even as he executed this killer attack. The Lumihilator could be described by one word, fast. It vastly surpassed all other techniques in this area, and it was able to continuously change directions. Generally speaking, experts on the same level as the wielder would at most be able to block three or four times before they were no longer able to handle the changes in direction and were defeated. To date, when fighting opponents on the same level, Dao Lord Yenmi had only ever seen opponents rely on special techniques such as invulnerable bodies to endure this attack. In all his life, he had only encountered two figures who were able to actually use their weapons to block this attack, with Ning being the second of the two. The first was the legendary number one expert of the entire Endless Territories. But of course, back then the man had merely been a Dao Lord of the third step. He really is quite fast. Incredibly fast, in fact, and the changes in direction are fast as well. This single attack is virtually all-encompassing and omnipresent. Its speed and agility alone allows the wielder to dominate much of the Endless Territories and defeat the vast majority of Dao Lords. However, its actual close combat techniques are fairly weak. Its defenses are quite weak, and its attacks are excessively fixed and not sufficiently unpredictable. I'm able to easily tell where the next attack will be coming from. This was Ning's private evaluation. Anyone faster than him would be able to defeat this attack with ease. However, Ning also knew that this current level of speed was in spite of his heart world projection and his Yin Yang sword domain. Even the most supreme of Dao Lords like Ninedust would generally be unable to keep up with these attacks. As for the Radiant King, he himself was already able to move at 100 times the speed of light. One could imagine how fast his Lumihilate would be. Failed. Failed. Failed again, Dao Lord Yenmi was increasingly anxious. He had launched more than 1,000 attacks in an incredibly short period of time, but all of them had been blocked by Ning. Ning was clearly much slower than him, but Ning's defenses were so airtight, flawless, and perfect that he wasn't able to find a single opening at all. I've tested out both of your killer attacks, and they seem quite a so-so. Time for my counter-attack. Ning's heart force instantly surged out, silently and soundless infiltrating Dao Lord Yenmi's body. At present, Ning had two incredibly powerful heart force attacks. This was his second one, the Dream Star. The Heart Force Eradicator focused on a head-on clash, while the Dream Star focused on illusions. Dao Lord Yenmi had been focused on this furious battle, but he suddenly sensed his soul and true soul being entranced. Illusions began to appear in front of him, but he instantly brought himself back into wakefulness as his mind let out a furious shout, destroying the illusions before him.
Boom!
However, right at this moment, Ning's right hand pierced directly through his chest. Dao Lord Yenmi was stunned. He realized that in the end, the illusions had disrupted his concentration after all, albeit for just a brief instant, but he had slowed down during that instant, allowing Ning to seize the opportunity to strike him. What's going on? Ning was surprised as well. He should have an eternal armor protecting his body. Why was I able to so easily pierce into his chest? Dao Lord Dark North, you are very powerful. Your close combat skills are just as strong as your heart force skills. Dao Lord Yenmi ignored the heavy injury as he stared at Ning, then sighed. I imagine it will be difficult to find anyone on our level of power who is capable of defeating you. Most likely, only the most supreme of first-tier Dao Lords would be able to beat you. You've beaten me, and I have no excuses to make. Whoosh! Dao Lord Yenmi's body instantly dissipated into countless streams of radiant light. The light quickly reassembled into a second Dao Lord Yenmi off in the distance. He stared at Ning, then smiled. This is what the true secrets of having a body of light incarnate are all about. Not only can my body transform into countless clones, I'm also virtually invulnerable.
Although you are a bit stronger than me, you aren't able to kill me.
Alas. I had been hoping to find a chance to improve my odds, but I ended up running into someone like you. It seems my chances of acquiring the Void Sea Jade Seals really are slim. After speaking, he turned and took a single step forwards, then vanished without a trace. Ning continued to stare in the direction Dao Lord Yenmi had disappeared into. He murmured softly, "A body of light incarnate?" All second-tier Dao Lords had extremely strong life-preserving abilities. Kong San, for example, was nigh invulnerable thanks to his darkness incarnate body. Dao Lord Yenmi's life-preserving ability was just as strong as Kong San's had been. Beating him wouldn't be difficult, but actually killing him would be very difficult. And similarly, killing Ji Ning would also be extremely difficult. Within the Wave Shift realm, a white-robed youth whose long golden hair glimmered with radiance was strolling slowly through the realm. The youth was quite handsome, and none of the other cultivators dared to even look him directly in the eye. He was the Radiant King, one of the truly supreme Dao Lords of the Endless Territories, ranked at the very top of the listings. I told him long ago. Dao Lord Soul Sky would merely leave his avatar at Vast Heaven Palace, with all the other disciples having led long ago. Clearly, Dao Lord Soul Sky has already decided to let his avatar perish in battle if need be. The Radiant King shook his head. Yenmi and the others, however, still harbored their foolish illusions and hoped to gain some intelligence. To Soul Sky, that information represents his chances of succeeding in the Dao Merge. How could he possibly be willing to tell others about it? Only those weak Dao Lords would harbor any illusions that they would win the information from him. All of the truly powerful Dao Lords chose to waste no time in heading straight to the Wave Shift realm. Every single moment might give them an advantage in acquiring the Void Sea Jade Seals. A hint of a smile was on the Radiant King's face. The Desolate Era. Chapter 24, Entering the Wave Shift Realm. The three spacetime tunnels of the Brightshore Kingdom were used quite frequently in recent days, because quite a few wandering Verge-level Dao Lords had hastened back and traversed them en route to the Badlands territory. Whoosh! A white-robed youth emerged from the dark vortex exiting one of the tunnels. Dao Lord Dark North. Suddenly, a voice called out to him. Ji Ning turned his head, only to see a smiling, golden-robed elder beam at him. Dao Lord Dark North. Dao Lord Goldsaber? Ning recognized the old man. That I am. I feel quite embarrassed when I look at you. It took this old man years to reach the verge as a Dao Lord. Just a short while ago, you were a world-level cultivator, but now you are more powerful than me. I heard that even the junior Radiant King, Dao Lord Yenmi, was unable to defeat your avatar. Impressive, truly impressive, the golden-robed elder sighed. Word of the battle between Ning's avatar and Dao Lord Yenmi had indeed spread throughout the Endless Territories. In truth, Soul Sky and Battlemaster had done this on purpose, so as to ensure that the other Dao Lords would give up their fantasies and withdraw. I've heard some important information that I'm not sure if you are aware of, Dao Lord Dark North, the golden-robed elder said.
What is it?
Ning asked. Just a few hours ago, Winesage of the Dark Kingdom has appeared in the Badlands territory. By now, he's already entered the Wave Shift realm, the golden-robed expert said solemnly.
Winesage?
Ning's face turned slightly pale.
Winesage of the Dark Kingdom?
He was one of the legends of the entire universe, because he was now publicly acclaimed as the number one Dao Lord of all the Endless Territories. It was actually something of a joke. The most powerful Dao Lord of the Noble Endless Territories actually stemmed from the outsider organization known as the Dark Kingdom. Alas, no one could deny how terrifyingly strong Winesage was. Anyone in any era who was publicly acknowledged as being number one possessed truly incredible power. Dao Lord Featherdress herself had been the number one Dao Lord of her era. Winesage was supposedly skilled in the Dao of Darkness, and he was also a Heart Force cultivator. The legend said that as a child, he was born into and grew up within a world of slaughter. The Dark Kingdom was an outsider organization, making it very difficult for them to truly establish themselves in the Endless Territories.
Thus, all of the geniuses who grew up within the Dark Kingdom were extremely violent and brutal, with the Dao Alliance not intervening at all. It was hard to imagine the difficulties and torments which Weinzig experienced. As a result, he became a notorious alcoholic, using alcohol to douse away his worries, but in one alcohol-induced dream, he suddenly came to master an incredible heart force art known as the Slaughter Fiend Field. It was only expected that Weinzig would go to the Wave Shift Realm. Ning was quite calm. Now that the Void Sea Jade Seals have emerged, I imagine that most of the most powerful Dao Lords will all go there. Given Weinzig's power, how could he not? That's not the only thing I have to share, the golden-robed elder said. Weinzig actually acquired a universe treasure.
What?
Ning called out in astonishment, a universe treasure? Are you sure about that?
Dead.
Sure. Brother Dark North, I heard this just a short while ago myself. I imagine that you'll receive word soon as well, the golden-robed elder said. The Wave Shift Realm is in a state of chaos right now, and many of the Dao Lords who aren't confident in their chances have begun to gather together into groups. More than 10,000 Dao Lords of the Dao Alliance joined forces to set up a grand formation outside the Wave Shift Realm to prevent the Ionians and the Dao Lords of the Dark Kingdom to enter the realm. And indeed, they were able to stop the Dao Lords of both organizations for a time. However, when Weinzig appeared and was faced with the grand formation set up by over 10,000 Dao Lords of the Dao Alliance, he ended up using his universe treasure and forced a way into the Wave Shift Realm.
A universe treasure?
Ning still couldn't believe it. He had run into several universe treasures by now. The first one had been the Shattered Sword in the Sword Palace, while the second had been the Indigo Greatsword of the Sword Hegemon in the Genesis Lands of the Alternate Universe. The third had been within that cave deep inside the Terror Star Sea, the longstaff that had been left behind by that ancestor of the ancient cultivators. None of them, however, had taken a liking to Ning. There was no way to bind universe treasures by force. This was a case of the weapon choosing the wielder, rather than the wielder choosing the weapon. Every single universe treasure contained a truly inconceivable amount of power. He was already the number one Dao Lord of the Endless Territories. If he has a universe treasure, he's going to be absolutely unstoppable. The golden-robed elder sighed. And, to me, it's inconceivable that a universe treasure would ever choose a Dao Lord. When Dao Lords fail their Dao merge, death is a certainty. Based on what I know, Weinzig has already been alive for an extremely long period of time. I imagine he only has a few thousand chaos cycles left before he reaches the limits of his lifespan. Ning nodded. Generally speaking, universe treasures would only choose eternal emperors. The number of Dao Lords in the Endless Territories who had acquired universe treasures could be counted on one hand. Fellow Daoist Dark North, are you planning to go to the Wave Shift Realm as well? The golden-robed elder asked.
Yes.
Ning nodded. Would you like to travel with me? The golden-robed elder immediately asked.
No need.
I've already made an appointment with a friend, Ning explained.
Then I won't force it.
The golden-robed expert knew that he was much weaker than Ning and would just slow the latter down. Although my chances are slim, I'm still going to go to the Wave Shift Realm. If I go, I'll at least have a slim chance.
Huh.
However, I'm definitely going to work together alongside a group of other Dao Lords. We're not like those Supreme Dao Lords who dare to travel solo or in small groups. Ning couldn't help but sigh. For the sake of the Dao merge, even the weaker Dao Lords were still willing to risk it all. Word quickly spread like wildfire throughout the Endless Territories, stunning everyone.
Weinzig?
What an interesting kid. The Netherlily Hegemon of the Ancient Cultivators smiled with praise. Every member of the Dark Kingdom is a madman. They are crazy towards themselves and even crazier towards their descendants. Still, they ended up rearing a fine young fellow. The Windrain Hegemon was perpetually in a state of slumber, but he had woken up due to this business with the Void Sea Jade Seals. Dark North and Birchaloo are both Heart Force cultivators as well. I had thought that they would have a shot at overtaking Weinzig once they became Dao Lords of the Fourth Step, but it seems that hope is gone. The almighty Brightshore Hegemon shook his head.
Their only chance lies in acquiring a universe treasure of their own, but that chance is far too slim. It wasn't that the Brightshore hegemon underestimated Ning and Birchaloo. Rather, it was that universe treasures simply contributed an overwhelming amount of power to their wielders. Within Vast Heaven Palace, Ning's avatar and Solisky's avatar were holding a meeting.
Dark North, are you sure about entering the Waveshift realm? Dalord Solsky asked.
I'll get there in a few years, Ning said. If I miss this opportunity, a second one like it may never come again. Of course I have to go in. I have a friend as well who is a member of the ancient cultivators and who is even stronger than I am.
Solsky nodded and said heavily, if you are going to go inside, take this.
As he spoke, he handed over a jade slip. This, as soon as Ning saw the jade slip, he had an idea as to what it was.
This is everything which I know regarding the Waveshift realm, Dalord Solsky said seriously.
I can't accept this.
Ning hesitated.
This would give him a faster starting point and let him maintain a lead over this opponent's.
Dalord Solsky had entered much earlier than the other Supreme Dalords had, and he had Dalord Badland's incarnation assisting him.
Given Badland's mastery over Numerancy, the two had no doubt learned a great deal regarding the Waveshift realm.
This information truly would be priceless.
2 years ago, Badlands and I encountered King Gorsh.
Dalord Solsky said softly, fortunately, Badlands
managed to take advantage of some of the formations and barriers within the Waveshift realm itself to trick King Gorsh, allowing us a narrow escape.
The Waveshift realm is now filled with many dangers.
Even though I have Badlands helping out, I'm not sure that I can avoid all these dangers, Dalord Solsky said.
However, you must remember that no one else besides you is permitted to read this.
You aren't allowed to tell a second person about this.
We're brothers, you and I, but I don't owe anyone else this.
Understood.
Ning nodded.
After you go inside, be careful.
From what I've heard, the top 10 Dalords of the Endless Territories have all gone inside.
There are also some low-key, little-known Dalords who are just as powerful as them who have also gone inside, Solsky instructed.
You need to be careful as well, Big Brother.
I'll try to join up with you as soon as I can, Ning said.
After leaving the Terror Star Sea, Ning had relied on his dimension-transcending abilities and the Brightshore Kingdom space-time tunnel to hasten towards the Badlands territory.
Despite that, it still took him 112 years before arriving.
Two figures emerged from a dimensional tunnel to appear in the void above the Badlands Everworld.
Brother Ninedust, you can go to the Waveshift realm first.
I'll meet up with you in an hour, Ning said.
Is there something you need to do? The Ninedust sect lord asked.
I need to make a few arrangements.
Ning didn't explain.
Got it.
I'll wait for you, but hurry up.
Don't dawdle.
We're already years behind most of the other Dalords, the Ninedust sect lord said.
Ning nodded, then opened up yet another dimensional tunnel.
Ning was heading to the Three Realms.
The Three Realms was separated from the Badlands territory by layers of dangers. Ordinary teleportation methods were useless against these regions.
However, Ning's ability to transcend space allowed him to move directly to the Three Realms.
He was going to place his most important Dao cultivating treasure, the Stone Sensor of Reunion, within the Three Realms alongside his primal twin.
The skies outside above the Waveshift realm.
Ning and the Ninedust sect lord had gathered together here.
So many people.
Ning and the Ninedust sect lord stared at the vast, seemingly endless cloud-shrouded realm that lay before them.
This was the Waveshift realm, and an endless cluster of figures could be seen outside of it.
Dao lords, tens of thousands of Dao lords.
They had set up an absolutely enormous formation which covered the entire Waveshift realm.
I heard that Weinzage was able to break through this formation and force his way inside.
Quite a few of the Dao lords of the Dark Kingdom and the Ionians managed to charge inside alongside him.
The Ninedust sect lord sighed.
Just looking at the formation, I can tell that I'm far from being a match for Weinzage.
No confidence in yourself?
Ning smirked.
Plenty of confidence.
The Void Sea Jade Seals aren't necessarily going to be won by the strongest,
the Nine Dust Sect Lord quickly said.
Then cut the crap.
Let's go on in.
Ning urged.
Let's go.
The two transformed into streaks of light that flew straight towards the realm before them.
That's Dao Lord Dark North.
Oh, Dao Lord Dark North of our Dao Alliance.
The 10,000 plus weak Dao Lords who were part of the Grand Formation didn't move to stop Ning or the Nine Dust Sect Lord.
The Aeonians and the members of the Dark Kingdom would all be stopped, but all others were granted entry.
Hurry up and let them inside.
Dao Lord Dark North seems quite confident.
He actually dares to go inside with just one other Dao Lord partner.
Dao Lord Dark North's avatar alone is stronger than Yenmi.
How strong must his true body be?
The other Dao Lords all chatted amongst themselves.
Ning and Nine Dust, the two were significantly less well known than the likes of Fiend Queen Dustrain, Weinzage, Palace Lord Dawnstar, or the Radiant King. However, when they joined together they were definitely on par with the most elite of Dao Lords.
There were actually quite a few who were like Ning and Nine Dust, both incredibly powerful and comparatively low-key.
I'm more powerful than you, but as of right now you seem to be more famous than me.
That kinda pisses me off.
The Nine Dust Sect Lord sent Ning a disgruntled mental complaint as they flew forwards together.
That's because you've been too low-key, Ning sent mentally.
Yes, yes I have.
The Nine Dust Sect Lord agreed.
Now that I've become a Dao Lord of the fourth step, I need to find a suitable opportunity to spread my name throughout the Endless Territories.
Hell, I should at least rank in the top 10 in the Endless Territories.
You'll have plenty of opportunities in the Waveshift realm.
All you need to do is just pick one of the other top 10 and beat them, and you'll instantly rise to fame, Ning said with a laugh.
Watched by over 10,000 Dao Lords, the two flew through the formation and advanced into the Waveshift realm, shoulder by shoulder.
Please subscribe to A7 English Podcasts and enjoy listening every day with us. Thank you.